welcome to Sewing Quarter. I'm Natasha McCarty. You've got me for the next 4 hours, and we have a brand new guest today. Yes, Jenni Smith will be joining us. So let's see how today is shaping up. Oh, yes. So coming up today, winter blooms. 8 a.m, miss it, miss out. Fabrics that we either aren't getting back in stock or we've only got a little bit left and we're not sure when we're reordering. That's it. If you've loved it, grab it. Don't miss out on that. 9 a.m, sweet bouquet quilt, which is what is the stunning one behind me. Which is the stunning one behind me. English today, sorry, I'll get there. 10 a.m, we then have Kaffe Hour. We've got some stunning charm packs for you. We've got fabric by the half metre and we've got some books. Beautiful. And then at 11 a.m, Hothouse Flower Cushion. A little bit of foundation paper piecing for you. Oh yes, broken down into really easy chunks. So that's what we have coming up today. Now, we'd love to hear from you. As ever, we'd love to hear from you. And here's how you get in touch. So if you head to the website, which is sewingquarter.com, and on there, you have a little click on watch. There it is. And then we will come up on your screen. Da, 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 da. And just underneath on the right-hand side is a box which says message the studio. That comes straight through to this morning. It's producer Paul. Good morning, producer Paul. So you can say, hello, producer Paul. Hello, studio. That will come through to us here in the studio. If you've got pictures to send, because we always love to see your quilts and everything else, then here we go. Email us, which is studio@sewingquarter.com. So then you can attach any images. And obviously, if you're attaching them, then we are assuming you have given us the okay to show those on air. Now, it is Miss It, Miss Out, but I would just like to draw attention to this stunning quilt behind me. That is next hour with brand new guest Jenni Smith. So don't miss out on that either. It's a bit good, isn't it? Look at that. Utterly stunning. Yes, now. Miss it, miss out. Let's crack on. Now, yesterday, we had 3 Rhapsody quilts left. This is one of the Rhapsody fabrics. Utterly stunning. Look at that. Now, we don't have very much of this left. I don't know when we're going to get it back in stock. Producer Paul, are we ever getting this one back in stock? Yes, but we don't know when. Okay, so £8.45. Look how stunning that is. That's for a half a metre of that. Beautiful. Okay, let's go through all of these pretty quickly. Now, we're not reordering this one at all. Here we go. It's a very handy one to have in your stash. Because of the two-toned blues, it's a really handy one to pop in there as a mixer. This is your Rustic Gate Blue. So again, not going to get this back again. £5.95 per half a metre. Get it today or you may never, ever see it again. Now, part of that range. Oh, I love this one. Why are we not? Are we not reordering this one again? Oh, look, this is from Andover Fabrics. A beautiful quilting weight fabric, but just look at that. Larger print, stunning, stylish, sophisticated. Just wonderful. That's your Cloud 9 Blue. This is Miss It, Miss Out. Get it in your basket. Check it out. You can check out as many times as you like. We will only charge you £2.95 per day. P&P. Hurrah. But you'll see that that goes beautifully with that one. We'll go through. I've got a whole selection of blues to work through with you so that we can see what goes with what if you're trying to put a collection together. Now, this is Linen Look here, which is fabulous for your bags, your craft projects, doorstops, bean bags, all those sorts of things in a lovely polka dot. Maybe your outside cushions, things like that, kitchen cushions, things like that. And I'm liking the price. £3.95 per half a metre. Yes, please. MIJQ37. That is your price for that. And that's a really handy one, again, to pop in your stash. Oh, stock warning. So meat, is that all we've got left? Meat, like basically this. We've got this in our stash. We're not reordering it. Now, this was from the Japanese range. Isn't it stunning? And you've got your Sashko stitches in the background. We had this with a kind of an ecru taupey type background as well. But this one is in the blue. We've had this in several kits now, and that's why we've got so little of it left. But it is, this is your Japanese garden. This is it. This is it. There is a metre of it left, and that's it. £5.95 per half a metre. Pop 2 in your basket. two items in your basket, and that is that gone. $5.95 YRMY02. This is never coming back on our screen ever, ever, ever again. So if you love it, pop it in your basket, grab it, pop it below, it's not coming back. Okay, now part of that range was the dragonflies. Again, not reordering, that's it now. Basically, we only have a finite amount of warehouse space, so we want to keep fabrics fresh and up to date for you. So when we've had a collection and we've had it for a while, it will go and we will get new stuff in. Exciting but sad if it's one that you've loved. So this was also part of the Japanese garden collection. So if you're getting this and maybe you're getting the one that we've just seen, they will go beautifully together. $5.95 WKMY84. Now, also part of that range, and again, won't be ordering this again. Will not be getting this again. This is the miss it, miss out hour. I will tell you which ones we might get back, but at the moment, this one will not be reordered. Producer Paul says that's unbelievable. Yeah. $5.95 there. Haha. That's your maple leaf in blue. Unbelievable doesn't work. Okay, now, one of my... Oh, I love this collection. This... Are we going to get these ones back? Tell me... Not really, but I love, love, love these. This is your Botanica bird collection. You know that stunning fabric that Paul Clark made the trousers out of for me back in August? This is part of that range. Your Botanica birds on vine blue. From Macawa, $5.95 per half a metre. Super stylish, what, how much have we got left? 2.5 metres left of that, then it's gone. Buying it already, check out your baskets. It's only confirmed when you check out your baskets. We don't charge you any extra P&P. P&P is only per day. So even if you just bought one item, it would be $2.95. If you bought 25 items, it would still just be $2.95 P&P. It doesn't matter how many times you check out your basket, we don't take the money and we don't apply the P&P until midnight. Okay, so that's that one. Now, I just, before I put that below Producer Paul, I want to show you it in the kind of creamy, linen-y textured background as well. So we have this one as well, same collection, but just different background. Not reordering, when it's gone, it's gone. This is your Botanica Birds on Vine Antique Fabric. Absolutely stunning, an absolute must, a truly beautiful fabric. Please do grab it if you want it, because this is the last time you're gonna see it here. Grab it or miss it, miss out. That's it. How much have we got of this one? Have we got a little bit more of that one? Yeah, not a lot more of this one. Not a lot. We've got 7 meters, that's 14 units. That's it. One person might just buy all 7, but you need to get it fast. And that's the way that this is. It's a fast hour. There we go. Right. Oh, what's this? Can I get rid of the bluebirds? Because they will probably go. We will re-update and let you know. Right, do you fancy a spot of Anna Maria Horner? We had this in yellow on the last Miss It, Miss Out hour. But now, here we go. This is your social climber, $6.95 per half a metre. Not always an easy designer to get hold of in this country. Anna Maria Horner, here it is, your social climber, which is the name of the rose. Absolutely gorgeous guest when we had her on. She looks amazing. Is it 6 kids she's now on? And she just... Is it seven? Oh, many, many, many children. And just looks incredible. Can't look haggard after one. So, right, there you go. Limited stock there on that one. But if you want it, and it is a beautiful fabric, please grab it now. Now, if you fancy a lovely dressmaking fabric, this is cotton satin. Yeah, Producer Paul loves this one. It is lovely for your dressmaking, absolutely perfect for your dressmaking, 150 centimetres wide, so you've got that extra length there, width rather. How much length you get is entirely up to you, because you can buy it by the half metre. We had Jennifer Mills make an absolutely stunning top out of this. Really beautiful. It hangs beautifully. Oh, a kimono, says Producer Paul. That's what he'd like out of this. Well, not possibly for him, but, oh, I don't know. You could rock a kimono, yes, Producer Paul. No one is judging. There you go. And you can see how wide that is. That really is. There we go. Love that. Feels gorgeous. And the drape, beautiful. Ah, now from one extreme to the other. So you've got that lovely soft cotton satin. And then check out this. Hang on, cameraman Mike, you wanted this, you wanted a similar one. It was a similar one. How about this one? Yeah. Low in quantity of this one. It's a little bit Escher-like, isn't it? That's what I always think when I see this one. This is your Nitro 3D fabric from New World Tapestry. Do you want to see the other side? Because this is what I love with this fabric. Wait here. Ba, ba, ba. Yeah, so reversible cushions maybe. And also what I love about this fabric is when I use fabrics like this, I often just keep the selvage as a feature of the fabric because you've got a nice little sort of almost tassel-y affair going on there. 80% cotton, 20% polyester, you can wash it. 140 centimetres wide, so it's a lovely wide fabric. You're getting a lot there. Lovely and thick, upholstery, cushions, all that sort of thing. Or just a throw, or bags, anything that you want a sturdier fabric for, that's your one. So $4.95 for that. Oh, now, if we want a fabulous price, for a throw, for pyjamas, this is brushed cotton, super super soft. We are not getting this again. I can tell you that at least two of my dogs have dog beds out of this, and it is so soft, and they just snuggle down in, and they absolutely love it. Freddie also has a pair of pyjama bottoms out of these as well. You know, I like the fact that my dogs and my little boy's trousers match. $3.75 per half a metre there. It is incredibly soft and snuggly, really lovely to use, and actually a lovely wide fabric as well. Selvage to selvage, what are we looking at? 135 selvage to selvage, so lovely and wide if you're dressmaking with it. Perfect for those pyjamas. Now, hello, I'm still here. Lots of you have popped stuff in your basket. Excellent, that's part of the process. To finish off the process and to actually get it, you need to check out. You can check out as many times as you like, especially on Miss It, Miss Out. You need to check out that basket because when it's gone, it's gone. And here's the thing. You might think it's safely sitting there in your basket, but someone could phone up customer services 0800 112 4433, UK free phone number, and they could just swoop in and grab it because they're there with their money ready to go, OK? So if you want it, check out your basket now, please. Oh, on a musical note, not ordering again. I'm thinking if you have anyone in your family of a musical vent, then why not grab them some musical fabric? Maybe you've got a grandchild or something that plays the flute or has piano lessons or anything like that. Then why not make them a music bag? Something to either take their instrument in or take their music, carry their music around in. You've got your quavers, your semi-quavers, you've got all sorts, your treble clef and all that kind of stuff. $4.95, DUMY16. Yes. So my husband says to me the other day, oh, it's great, I've got us a piano. Haven't played the piano since I was about 10. I've got us a piano. Right, how are we going to get this piano? Oh, it's fine, we'll just lift it into the back of the van. Went through the floor of the van. Never mind. Now, this is a great fabric. No, it wasn't a grand piano, it's just an upright, but it wasn't so much, it was just the floor of the van, it's now gone through that, got a little hole. Now, 137 centimetres selvage to selvage. I've made dog beds out of this. What else do I make? I mean, this is just like and repeat. So, for me, dog beds were lovely out of this. It's a nice, thicker cotton going on here. It's a really lovely cotton, and also because if you've bought any of our teals or creams, or if you bought the cream and brown bundle yesterday, you'll have colours to go through in that. It's kind of embroidered, yeah, so it's got that lovely detail there. You could make some beautiful cushions out of this. You could get some of the Scandi hearts and things and complement it like that. You can pick out the reds, you can pick out the teals, you can pick out the creams. It's really lovely. Well, what I did, producer Paul, was I put some teal, I put teal sashing around it. I had that as like the main panel of the dog bed and then put teal sashing all the way around. And Arthur is very happy on it. That's his bedroom bed. They have beds in different rooms. Oh, a little update. Japanese garden sold out. We knew that. The botanical birds in blue. You haven't checked out, so it's still there. You need to check out your basket. We've got more of you with it in your basket than we actually have stock. So please check out your basket. Don't miss out on that. But this is very, very lovely. Cushions, all that sort of thing. Bean bags, all that harder wearing. So a thicker fabric. Beautiful. Oh, have these not got... Hang on, no. Did we have these in a different colour last time? I can't believe we still have these. Love the elephants. Limited stock of them. Don't know when it's going to come back. Now, oh, I've got a bit of fluff in my eye. Our first ever male guest, Paul Clark, has a gorgeous shirt out of this fabric. It's a really soft, lovely weight to work with if you're dressmaking or anything like that. Yeah, no, it's a lovely red, isn't it? It's like a clarity red. £3.55 per half a metre. 110 centimetres width, so if you are using this for dressmaking, you might need a little bit more, but it is, look, how soft that is. It is a beautiful weight for your dressmaking. Paul's shirt looks gorgeous in it, and I think that we should commission him to make one for John Scott as well. Just lovely, absolutely beautiful fabric, and I think you should have it. How much of that have we got left? Do we know? Are we getting much more of it left? Is this we're never getting it again? Oh, we might not see it for a little while. So we've got 10 metres, and when that's gone, basically, so many in your basket, please check out, says producer Paul. It might have gone, don't know. Check out or ring up the website there. Now, here we go. Fabric you can colour in, yes, in which case you need these pens, which are incredibly affordable, super affordable. Here they are. These are your textile marker pens. They are dual-nibbed. So what you'll see here is a thicker nib that end, thinner nib for detail work there. So let me show you the difference between those. There it is. Now, you can wash these at 40 degrees. If you want to set it fast, just iron it. Just press it, and look, they are really lovely. So what we've got for you today is your Michael Miller fabric. And it's a really lovely fabric because you can colour it in. So whether you want to do... We'll have a look at the one that we've got in just one moment, but just to give you an idea, these pens are just brilliant and incredibly affordable. You know, sometimes you look at these pens and they're just so expensive, but I think this is something lovely that you can sit down, do with the kids, they can get involved, they can colour their own things in, but it's really, really easy. You've got that detailed nib, or if you want to cover more area, then you can. And you can also do some sort of shading with it if you want to. But also, if you go back in again, you can get more depth of colour. So the more you go in, the more you can shade with these pens as well. So they're your fabric markers, £12.95, super affordable, really lovely. And look, these are things that we've done with this kind of stuff before. So we've had cushions out of it where we've just taken up a little bit of detail. And then this is the fabric that we've got for you today. So... imagine giving your child a teddy bear that they can colour in a bag. So if you had the bear in the bag pattern, then you could make it out of this fabric. Let me show you the fabric. Very, very limited, so please get it quickly. 4 metres left. Look, someone's already started having a little colour in there. Well, this happens with this fabric. We go, have we got any of that? Yeah. Oh no, someone's had a little colour. They've done a good job, though, haven't they? It's lovely. No, I think it might have been Amy. I think she's done a cracking job. It's lovely. But you can see there, you can blend the colours through. So if you're using those marker pens, they are really easy to use. No, the butterflies were mine over there on that cushion. I did those ones. There we go. But only a few metres left of that. Let me stuff that under there. Oh, now... I really fancy some of this for my bathroom, for like a wash basket and things like that. 4 metres of this left. This is your linen look beach hut fabric. Yes, you could make a blind out of it. It's a blinding idea, yes. It does have a looser weave, but it's a sturdier sturdier fabric. It's a thicker fabric here. Fabulous for cushions. Maybe you want to have make a deck chair or something like that out of it. But there's only 4 meters left. $4.95. NSFG 64 is your code for that. Now, you might have thought that that was it on the elephant front. But oh no, oh no. Check out these elephants. Just 5 meters of these wonderful elephants. Again, shirts, tops, dresses. Brilliant. Bags, anything you like. But it is of super fine fabric. Lovely, lovely to work with. $3.55. So it's got a very lovely drape on it if you are making this for clothes or anything like that. Oh, lovely idea. Director Tim said he's going to make a memory book and cover it in elephants. 5 meters. Is it? Well, it's all right. It's not a big memory book. You can still get grab some of that. But that's all you've got. 5 meters of that, and you've got to be quick. Okay. Oh, bunnies. Bunnies, bunnies. Again, this is your linen look fabric here. Oh, there's a hare on it. I was... Look out. I always feel really privileged when I see a hare. Yeah, no, I got the joke first time around Producer Paul. So there's a hare there on there. 3 meters, that's all we have left of the hares. Miss it, miss out. They're gone. Whooshed, and they do hop quickly. $4.95. Do hares hop, or do they... They do box. What else do hares do? Yeah, I don't know. $4.95, if you know. I'm sure there's special terminology for hares. ZIFG 61. There's something very special about hair. I do love them. Right, let's pop that down there. We'll update you in just... Zebras, yes. $3.55 for your zebras. What a cracking price. Are we getting these back? Please tell me we're getting these back. Please. We haven't reordered it yet. Let's miss it, miss out. If everybody buys this today, I don't know when it's back. We all love the zebras. We all love the zebras in the studio. There are your green zebras. I've got this in a scarf in blue. I love this fabric. $3.55, HYJQ35 for your zebras in green. It's lovely. It's a really lovely fabric. Just a bit of fun. You could line a jacket in it, says Producer Paul. You could. What else could you do? Bags, all that kind of stuff. It's going to look good. Maybe you fancy a zhuzhi zebra in red. Zhuzhi zebras. It's really striking, isn't it, in the red? But you could do contrast. You could do... It's what, Producer Paul? Oh, he says it's vivacious. There you go. $3.55, WCJQ53. Paul's got his thesaurus out, everyone. Careful. $3.55, what a great price for a cracking fabric. I feel like we've moved into the animal quarter here. We've had elephants, hares, zebras, and now we're moving on to dogs. Who let the dogs out? Here they are. There you go. $3.55 again. What fabulous prices. Brilliant prices. Multi-directional hounds here. Sort of Westie types, aren't they? $3.55. Is he just trying to find his way out? He's got a quizzical expression on his little face. He's like, am I going the right way? $3.55, VHJQ42. Yeah. Not reordering this, which is a shame. But if you love an ice cream, and who doesn't? Here we go. But don't eat it. But... Maybe you want to start... Maybe you're having a winter break in the sunshine. Then take yourself some happy fabric with you. $6.95. This is Erin McMorris. We don't stock a lot of Erin McMorris. But when we do, it's always incredibly popular. So we're not getting this back again. Again, when it's gone, it makes room for new fabrics to come in. So $6.95. Have we got much of that? We're okay at the moment. We're not reordering it, but miss it, miss out. That is not coming back in again. So when it's gone, it's gone. Now, oh, producer Paul, don't tell me that these aren't coming back in. What about the ticking? Don't know when we're going to see these again. Yeah, this is the grey ticking. I love ticking. Ah, ticking should always be a part of it. Now, this is yarn dyed ticking. Okay, so the colour is already dyed when it's woven. So the colours are woven through rather than it being printed on. So that's 4.55 per half a metre. This is fab, again, for cushions, dog beds, bean bags, all that kind of stuff, bags, all those things that you want a soft, durable fabric. It's all there. ZKJQ24. I made Freddie a fabulous, well, I think it's fabulous, a great big Union Jack bean bag, and I put ticking all the way around it. So I had a great big Union Jack panel and then put blue ticking all the way around it, and it's just brilliant. It's got that little bit of give and that softness to it. It's really lovely. So I would always recommend the ticking. We've done lots of chef's aprons, things like that out of it, kitchen stuff, great for all of that. A really handy one to have in your stash. You can never have too much ticking. Here's it in a light blue. Lovely. Lots of you adding it into your baskets, but please check out. It is not yours until you check out the baskets. That's what we need to say. And there's not as much stock of this one as there is of the grey. So if you're after the blue, and it is particularly lovely, then please check out your baskets. It's only £4.55 per half a metre. It's a fabulous price. And remember, your P&P is done per day. So once you've got one item in the basket, you may as well throw a few more in my humble opinion. £4.55, ATJQ35. Right. Let's pop that down there. Now, lots of you going for that. Now, enzyme washed linen effect fabric. This is our last fabric of the hour. Miss it, miss out. Now, this is perfect for your linen type trousers. It acts like linen. This is your enzyme washed linen look in a dusky pink. It's a really soft, flattering colour. I love this colour. Really suits, well, actually, I was going to say it really suits blondes, but actually it's that sort of colour that suits everybody. It's almost purple, but it's that dusky, dusky pink. £5.95 per half a metre. This is quite wide, isn't it? Look at that. What's that? 140. Yeah, that is lovely and wide. So if you are making anything out of it, that would be lovely in a jacket. Yes, a linen look jacket. Fabulous. Excellent. That is all the fabric that is miss it, miss out. But just imagine, as soon as these have gone, then we can get new fabrics in. That's a lot of new fabrics. Right, let's have a look at stock levels then. Come on, producer Paul, hit me with it. What have we got? Nitro 3D. Almost sold out. Okay, how much of this do we have left now then, producer Paul? He's just going to check everybody's baskets and see how much we've got left. This is it in its full glory. We've got 2 metres left. That's it. That's 4. And 2 people with it in your baskets. If you've ordered a metre each, then that's it, gone. This is £4.95 per half a metre. Please check out your basket. If you're one of those 2 people with it in your basket, please check out or it will not be yours. TJFG48, it's only £4.95 per half a metre. This is a really affordable fabric. It's double-sided as well. It's super thick. You can upholster in this. You can make your cushions out of this. Anything that needs to be a bit more hard-wearing. If you've got a bag, maybe you've got some faux leather you want to mix through with it, that would be lovely. That would be amazing, actually. Yeah, imagine that as half bag, half faux leather. Yeah. What's that? Sorry, producer Paul, I was getting it. The what-y what? Oh, beach huts. I thought you said Beatrix. I was like, oh, a fabric called Beatrix. Beach huts. Am I putting that away, by the way? Is that going to go? Leave it out for now, just to tease you. Check out your baskets for that one. Beach huts. If everybody checks out. Oh, there's a metre and a half left. There's a metre and a half left. If you're after your beach huts, And I think this is going to look great for either outdoors or in your bathroom. Fabulous. And a great price, $4.95. NSFG 54. Do you want to see how wide it is, actually? Because these are lovely wide fabrics. I want a linen basket and matching blind out of this for my bathroom. Look at that. It's 80-20, 80% cotton, 20% polyester. And I would say that's either 140 or 150 width. It's a really wide fabric. NSFG 54, which means that you're getting a lot for your money. A lot of bang for your buck. That's what they say, isn't it? There we go. Now, am I keeping that out or keep it out for now? I'm going to have, this is going to be like my my almost gone department over here. Red elephants. Let's have a look at those little chaps. What? What has? Oh, the hairs. Have the hairs gone? Oh. Have they? Half a metre left. If you're after the... Oh, lots in your baskets. Please check out your baskets. If you're after the hairs, check out your baskets because otherwise it's gone. $4.95 per half a metre. If you have that in your basket, please check out or it will not be you that gets it. And that would be sad if it's you that wanted it. So if you had a metre in your basket, please check out your baskets now. I don't want anybody missing out. I'm going to put that to one side because I think that's going to go. So we've already had three sellouts effectively. Yeah, no, that's what I mean. Two there and then the hair, because that's going to go. So I'll count that as a sellout. Oh, it's gone. It's gone. Well done if you managed to get it. Now, we were talking red elephants, weren't we? As you do, you know. What day is it today? Wednesday. Red elephants. Here we go. Here are your red elephants. Looking good. This is your red elephants. They're a lovely... they're almost maroon on ecru. They're just fun. Fun elephants. And they are $3.55 per half a metre, so a fabulous price. What did we say these were? 110 centimetres wide? I think so. I do believe so. So if you are making any clothes out of this, just get that half metre extra. But it's lovely and soft. It is 110. But it's a beautiful soft fabric. Lovely for that. Do you want... Yeah. How much of this have we got left? It's on the endangered list, isn't it? Miss it, miss out. Here we go. 5 metres left, that's it. So that could be... Don't know when we're going to reorder it. We might not. Might not come back. Depends if we remember. There we go. There are your elephants. 5 metres of that left. That's 10 units. That's it. That's all there is left of this. Please check out your baskets. Lots of you sitting with this in your baskets. Please check it out if you want it. Don't miss out on it. It's only $3.55 per half a metre. Yeah. Oh, now. The first fabric of the hour. Am I putting this on the endangered list over here, these elephants? Not yet. Now, the first time, I can't believe that this is in Miss It, Miss Out, because this was only the first time I saw this yesterday. Look how stunning that is. It reminds me of a fine china. And it's just exquisite. So yesterday we had a Babbling Brook Plains bundle that went absolutely perfectly with this. So if you got the Babbling Brook bundle yesterday, then just know that those blues tonally work exquisitely with this. This was part of the Rhapsody quilt that we had yesterday. It does look a bit like French wallpaper. It's got that regal type feel. I'm thinking that really beautiful blue china that you get. It's got that sort of feel. It's going to fit into all sorts of different environments. If you've got kind of quite a posh home, then that's lovely, it's going to work there. If you want to make it a little bit more shabby chic, it'll fit into that. It's a really versatile, easy, beautiful fabric to use. But then also look, if you're quilting with it, look at all of the different fussy cutting options you've got with this large print in the middle. You've got an option to use those. That would be stunning, wouldn't it? But you've got all of these that you can fussy cut with. Or maybe you just want that. Hang on, where's my best way to show it? That bit in the middle. So that bit. Or maybe you want that bit. Or maybe you want that bit. Or maybe that bit. That bit. That bit. That bit. There's so many options. There are so many options. It's entirely up to you. Oh, yeah. So producer Paul said that Lucy Brennan made a button, a self-cover button, and this would be lovely. Just because you could, yeah, you'd have to use sort of a little bit like that. Or these bits. Oh, Nitro sold out. Right, that's our fourth sellout of the day already, and it's... Producer Paul, you could rename yourself Nitro if you wish. He said, I wish I was called Nitro. Yeah, but look, because you've got... So, should we only call him Nitro? So, Producer Nitro says, imagine covering your buttons with that. So you could take out that smaller detail as well. If you are English paper piecing, again, you're fussy cutting. What this fabric allows you is lots of different sections. So if you wanted just to have a little leaf section on your English paper piecing, you could do that. If you wanted, with your larger patchworking, to just take sort of a framed section like that, you've got that. So it's a really versatile one to have in your stash. But of course, if you wanted to make the most of that larger print, if you wanted to make bags out of this, dress make out of this, it's absolutely stunning. Utterly stunning fabric, and it's 8.45 per half a metre, but worth every penny. Now, all the linen look dots, very, very popular. We've got an interesting mishmash on the show today. It just shows, doesn't it, the variety of fabrics that we actually stock. Everything from giraffes and linen to soft brush cotton to embroidered fabrics to ticking to... here we go. So this one here, look at this fabulous price, is your linen look cotton, and this is dots on blue. So £3.95 here. Ba, 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 ba. And do you know what I would put with that? I would put the grey ticking with it, because this is a slate blue, grey blue. But I think that if you put the grey ticking with it, how gorgeous is that together? But you will have to be quick. So your linen look cotton there, £3.95 per half a metre. And the ticking will give you the details for that in a minute. But I think those two together, classic combination, work beautifully. Hairs sold out. Hairs have gone. Yep, that's four sellouts already. And we've only got 20 minutes left. But stock's running incredibly low on a lot of these fabrics. Miss it, miss out. Do not miss out. Just check out your baskets. You can check out as many times as you like. Give our customer services a call if you're not sure. 0800 112 4433. So let's give you the details for the grey ticking. Just works a treat with these. If you want to make a chef's apron, then you can do that with it. Tim wants a chef's apron out of it. Are you a good chef, Tim? He'd like to say so. Should we be asking somebody else? Now, this is running incredibly low. If you have it in your basket, guess what? Please check out. £4.55, a fabulous price. £4.55, ZKJQ24. Stock warnings for the elephants, the colourful elephants. Let's put that to one side down there. Ba-ba-ba-ba. Let's put... Am I... Colourful elephants. Give me those colourful elephants. Here they are. Oh, yeah. No idea when this will be back. Do you know, I thought that this was the same design as the red elephants. It's not. It's slightly different. These are all trunks up. The others have got varied trunks. Now, if everybody checks out, this is probably gone, but look at all the different colours you could pull from there with your spectrum solids. Oh, it's gone. There you go. That was quick. Snooze, you lose this morning. If you're still snoozing, you're probably lost. Losing. You're probably losing if you're snoozing. Yeah, all of that. What are we going to look at next? The what? Ah, oh, I love the Cloud Nine. I can't believe we're not getting this back in again. Now this, we're not ordering again. This is a classy fabric, isn't it? Just look at that. Proper classy. Blue's always incredibly popular for your interiors. And this is just exquisite. Absolutely beautiful. A lovely tone of blue. Really, really gorgeous. Now, I'm going to show you part of the range, part of the same range was the gate that we had as well. I've made cushions and all sorts out of this, and it's a really beautiful one to work with. Now, it is perfect for quilting. It's a lovely quilting weight, both of these fabrics. But you can see that tonally, these guys work together beautifully. So if you want a contrasting fabric, if you're building up a stash for a quilt, then this is going to work beautifully. Beautiful. So this one here, we'll give you the details in a minute. This is Cloud Nine Bluebird. And that's the details there. £5.95 per half metre. When it's gone, it's gone. I just wish that everybody would have this. Now, this is a cream background. This is not a bright white background. So what I would say is that if you want to mix that through with a plain solid, go for something like an off-white. Don't go for a bright spectrum solid white. Go for a cream of some side or an antique white. So something softer. Or even actually, if you want to bring in your lighter browns, your latte tones, it works beautifully with those as well. It's that kind of tonal range. Oh, the cotton check. Oh, the brushed cotton, the tartan. Oh, well done if you managed to get that. Let's get rid of that. That's our fifth sellout of the hour. My word. Now, that one's gone. So, okay, that's the brushed cotton. That's gone. Well done if you got that. My dog bed one, has that gone as well? Gosh, look at all the gaps we're getting. Whoa, well done if you got that as well. It's a beautiful fabric to work with. Anything else that I need to be very aware of? Linen look dots that we just looked at, stock warning there. Right, I'm going to show you then. That Cloud Nine that we just had on is also going to work beautifully with a couple of other fabrics. Let me show you. Let me show you the birds, the botanical birds. Not from the same range, but tonally works beautifully together. So if you want to play with those two together, and then maybe also work in. Okay, so I've got a few different options going on, so bear with me. That was the Cloud Nine that I just showed you. There. That was your Cloud Nine. This one here is your Botanica Birds. Stunning. £5.95. Now, this was out of the Japanese range. That's your maple leaf. We'll give you details for that in a moment. But just look how well that all mixes through. So if you're looking for a variety to make a quilt or something like that, you could do worse than to put those together. Or if you want to bring in the pattern, we've just seen that one as well. So all of those. So I'm just having a little play. All of these fabrics you'll see underneath where we're live on the website. So if you want to, if they're still available, please grab them. So the Cloud Nine, absolutely stunning. The Botanica Birds is the details on the screen there. And this is your maple leaf out of the Japanese garden range. So let's give you the maple leaf one next. let's give you that detail. So that's that one. And if you want to see another colour out of that range, then we've got the dragonflies. So we'll just playing with these blues for you to get an idea. So this is your maple leaf. Now, the interesting thing is, the reason I've pulled out these other blues, and if you got, again, if you've got the babbling blue range yesterday, then it'll work in a treat, so you can get some planes with that. But you see, with the dragonflies here, that blue there is the same as the background blue there. So you start to pull those in. Maple leaf, we're not reordering. So if you want this, grab it. It's almost like a ditzy floral, but in leaf form. Yes, producer Paul, unbelievable. I know you didn't say it, but you were going to. Now, if you are going to mix through with up here, hang on, we'll get there. Yeep, deep, 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 deep. You'll notice that actually these leaves here, these darker leaves here are the same colour as this background here, which is the same colour as the dragonflies on there. So you've got that tie-in with the colours there. Mix that through with some creams and you've got a beautiful combination going on there. Just quite interesting. This is your dragonflies. We're not getting this back again. Please do grab. So not reordering dragonflies. How about putting it with that gate fabric? Works because you've got the same background colour there, and then you've also got where you've got that deep blue in the colour there, you've got that deep blue there, so you can mix those together. Different look, yeah. Do you like that? Producer Paul likes that. It could be a reversible cushion. Mix it through with some cream, and you've got a dark mid tone and a light. Now, cotton yarns. It's rustic gate, isn't it? Not rusty gate. Yeah, just checking. Now, cotton yarn is a stock warning for you there. So if you're after your yarn dyed, now yarn dyed just means that the fabric was dyed, and that's on your ticking, that the fabric was dyed before it was woven. So this isn't a printed fabric, this is all woven through, as you can see. So that's your grey, and then we've also got a lighter blue, which we haven't really focused on, but if everybody checks out, I think the light blue is gone. Miss it, miss out hour! Shall I put that to one side? Okay, hang on. I'm going to put that as a sellout. That's going to go. The linen look dots, well done, that's gone. If you've got the linen look dots, look, it goes beautifully with the grey yarn dyed. I think that's lovely. So that probably is also sold out, the grey. Let's put all of those away. Whoa, look at this. Suddenly looking very bare. Satin, the cotton satin. Now, we've dress made with this and it was beautiful. Really lovely to work with. It's got a lovely drape and a beautiful feel to it. Very soft, but it's got that satin sheen to it. So it's a very special looking fabric. Special to feel. You've got a... yeah, that Japanese style cherry blossom effect going through there. So $6.25. Both the boys upstairs think dressing gowns, kimonos, that sort of thing. But actually, as a shirt, as a work shirt, it was really beautiful that you could dress up, dress down. I've got a pair of... Yeah, this was the blouse that Jennifer Mills made my shirt out of. It was beautiful, really beautiful. And that had quite a big bow detail on there, but the drape on it was lovely. And you can only get away with a big bow like that with a fabric that will drape. So, rusty gate next. Rustic. Ba-ba-ba-ba, check out your baskets for that. Okay, rustic gate. Here it is. Now, this goes with the dragonfly. It goes with the dragonflies. We're not reordering it. It also goes with the Cloud 9 floral. And it goes with the maple leaf because you've got that blue going through. Different manufacturers for the for some of these, but the colours are there. And if the colours are there, quite frankly, it works. But that's the joy of being able to show it to you live on air. Now, you see, the one that it goes with from the collection that it comes from is that one. There. There. So that's what it goes with. But as we've seen, the Japanese range it works with as well. So this is your Cloud Nine. This is your Rustic Gate, or as John likes to call it, Rusty Gate. $5.95. Yeah, Rustic Gate there. Don't miss out. It's a really handy one to have. Stock warning! Blue, oh, the Blue Rhapsody, the beautiful Blue Rhapsody. It is an exquisite, exquisite fabric. A wall hanging? Producer Paul once says a wall hanging. I think wherever you can use that. You could, imagine bathroom curtains. Stunning. Do you know what? Pillows, pillowcases, kitchen cushions. Especially, my mum collects blue china. She collects Asiatic pheasant, which is your antique blue china. And that would look gorgeous thrown in her kitchen amongst those. How much of that have we got left, Producer Paul? Checking stocks there, basically check out your baskets. 8.45. Oh, the ice creams. Ice cream, you scream, we all scream for ice cream. We're not reordering, so no screaming. Okay, when it's gone, it's gone. No tantrums about that. Right, this is your ice creams. This is by Erin McMorris. We don't stock a lot of her fabrics. UK designer. Here we go. Bright, vibrant, fun. I think that sums that one up. Bright, vibrant, and fun with some really fabulous colours going on through there. So your teals, again, we put a lot of our spot on papaya through with this. That worked beautifully with this fabric. So if you want another fabric that's going to work with it, check out the website for that underneath the fabrics by the half metre. Then your spot on papaya is exactly that orangey shade. And then, you know, generally our teals, a lot of the spot-ons actually worked beautifully with this. And then it echoes the spots that you've got throughout. Nice, hey. Now, I can't believe there's any of the Michael Miller left. Gosh, do you remember when we first brought that to wear, Producer Paul? It went like that. So if you didn't manage to get it at the time, but you fancy... You see, this is the sort of project that we did with the Michael Miller fabric, was we made cushions that you could continue to colour in. I'll just prop that up there like that. If you made the Joe Carter teddy bear, how about this for a project? Making a Joe Carter teddy bear and then giving it so that you can colour in. So you give that and then your fabric pens. But here's the thing, because if you made the bag a little bit bigger... You can pop your pens in there as well. So how about that for a gift for a child? So you could make the bear, you can fit your pens in there, pop your bear in there, that's your gift done. Thank you very much. We're thinking about Christmas, birthdays, all those sorts of things. And then they get to colour in their very own teddy bear. So your Michael Miller Colour Me In fabric is in the Paisley Fish, which is one of my favourites. I love the paisley, you see, so. And if you've got any small children that like octonauts, they're going to love the fish. Look at that. There you go. Check out your baskets for that. It might be that you just want to highlight the fish, or it might be that you just want to highlight the paisley. Entirely up to you. Or it just be that actually you want to keep the grandkids quiet when they come to visit. Who knows? Now, you're going to need pens for this. The pens I've just popped away in the bag. And now I can't fit them all in. Okay, so you are getting... How many in here? I can't remember. It is 20, isn't it? So allow drying for up to 6 hours. Iron inside out for 5 minutes on the decorated area using a cotton setting, and that will mark it for fab... That will keep it then permanent. And then you can wash it at 40 degrees. And all that kind of thing, which is excellent. That's what we love. So grab those. Oh, zebras, zebras, zebras. Oh, 2 minutes, running low on time as well as on stock. Oh my goodness. Right, zebra in red. Yeah, again, this has a John Scott shirt written all over it. Look at that. Yours won't have anything written on it. Zebralicious. Designed for you by Poppy. £3.55, what a fabulous price, means that you can buy oodles of it. If only we had oodles, how much have we got left, Producer Paul? Very, very low on stock of this. £3.55, WCJQ53 is your code. Please grab it. It's great fun. You can pop a black, a white, or a red with that. You've got all sorts of fun you can have and really make that stand out. What am I looking at next? Green zebras. Yay. Hey, they work well together, actually. Yay. If you're after your green zebras, please check out your baskets as well. Again, another incredibly popular fabric there. So £3.55, fabulous price. HYJQ35. There we go. Now, after the break, brand new guest, Jenni Smith, is waiting in the wings in a gorgeous dress, actually. Just wait till you see this. And look what she's made us. Absolutely exquisite. I think that says it all. What a fabulous guest we're going to have up next. Brand new. She's pacing. Few nerves there, Jenni, but she's going to be fabulous because look at what she can create. And you can too. She's going to show us how after this very short break. So stay in tuned. Go and grab a quick cup of tea. Check out your baskets. Make sure that you don't miss it because this hour was miss it, miss out. Do not miss out. Stay happy. We'll see you in just a couple of moments. Follow us on Pinterest. Search for our sewing quarter page and follow us to discover sewing work we create and love.
Thank you, Tash.
It's
easy to buy the products you see on our shows. To buy any of the items featured on today's programmes, just head over to our website, www.sewingquarter.com.
Do they go back to the warehouse, Amy?
Click on the video stream and you'll be taken to our watch page.
Yeah.
Here you'll find the product that is on air right now at the top of the page. Beneath that, you'll find all the products demonstrated in this morning's shows. To add an item to your basket, simply log into your
account, Jen?
Or register with us.
You're
then
right.
You can either check out
or
keep shopping.
Sparkly shoes and
remember, our
dress.
Flat rate delivery charge lets you shop all day and check out as many times as you like and only pay once for postage and packers. Only on Sewing Quarter. Freeview Channel 78.
Okay, how would you like to be introduced? What would you like to be known at? Because obviously you're quilting today, but obviously dressmaking is also something that you do.
Yeah, I think they put out on the promo that I'm a teacher, a quilter, and a
So today I'm going to show you how to do a double stitch. Now you would use a double stitch at the start and the
any
end of your sewing to secure your
Excellent.
Threads rather than
know
using
there was
a
one that you
really big knot.
I think
you're going to want to take your needle through the front of your fabric first and then come out back through the front. So I'm using really big stitches at the moment so I can see what I'm doing.
Yeah, but
you're going to leave a tail
be tilted slightly
before you then repeat
like
that in and out motion.
Just so,
so
that
you can see that's one.
Basically you've got, yes Paul, hang on, just bear with me a minute.
Through again.
That camera up there.
Oh, yeah, and that's two.
Yeah,
so you can see I've done two stitches in the same place. That's giving me my double stitch. You would then do whatever stitch it is that you're going to go on to do. So I'm just going to do a quick running stitch.
As and when you need them. Just grab them. But yeah, and then just bring them into the centre here. So you've got your trolley there.
Okay. So now I'm going to do my double stitch at the very end of my stitch there. So it's repeating the process. So I'm going in.
Whatever. What page is this?
Back out.
57.
In.
Okay.
Out.
But I'll be starting over here. Okay.
My threads. So obviously you would clip these closer when you get to finishing your garment. So there you have it.
Do what? Do what? What does that mean? Yeah, what's up with my mic? Hello, Welcome back. Now, this hour, you have me, Natasha McCarty, but you also have a brand new guest. We'll be joining Jenni Smith in just one moment. Bear with me, excuse me. It's fluff off the fabric from the earlier hour. Now, lap and throw quilts is where the inspiration for the next quilt has come from. 12 different patterns and designs in this book, ranging from beginner through to advanced. You've got the whole range in here. So there's going to be something in there to suit everyone. Now, this is $12.95. All sorts of different designs and styles in here. So the one that we've got for you today is intermediate, but look at that. Some really striking designs in here. Modern comfort. And the one that we're looking at, so step by step, it breaks it down, shows you how to do it, how to piece it, how to put it together. Lots of different, there is literally something for everyone in here, which is just ideal and perfect. Now, page 57, I believe, is where our one is. Yeah, okay. So this is your sweet bouquets, which is the one that we've got on the wall today that we saw earlier. Now, there it is in purples, but we've got some stunning bundles for you. Now, this is a whopping bundle. Look how much fabric you're getting here. 8 metres in total. It's a lot of fabric. So, apple of my eye is this one here. Let's go for this one over here. I've got the graphics for apple of my eye, which is this one. Yeah. Now, whilst we squabble over which graphics we've got, this is the details on your screen are for this one. This is hand-picked fabric. This is apple of your eye. This is organic cotton. So this particular fabric, beautiful Wyndham Fabrics, and this is 100% cotton fabric. You're getting a metre of that. Isn't that absolutely fab? Now, to complement that, the colours that we've put with it are here. So you've also got within this bundle, here we go, all of that. So you've got that lovely orange and that green, which just go with all the colours through there. So a metre of the dandelion, a metre and a half of fern, a metre of spot-on cobalt, a metre of the apples, and you also get your thread, and there's 2.5 metres of that bright orange and a metre of blue sea. Fabulous. That's what you're getting in that bundle there. Now, this one is the one that we've got made up, which is just... oh, you'll be made up when you get it. Look, 8 metres again. This is your dashwood fabric range. So you've got these two as your feature fabrics in here. Love the birds. And then you've got those, the dark forest. It's a really gorgeous collection. So this is your deep forest. We launched this maybe 2 weeks ago. It really hasn't been with us for very long. Now with it, whoa! Look at that. Now, is that the berry or the azalea linear? I can never remember. It is azalea. So you're getting how much produced, Paul? The dashwood birds, you're getting a metre. The azalea, you're getting a metre. Citrus, you're getting 1.5 metres. Yeah. Deep orchid, 2.5 metres. The other dashwood with the trees on, you're getting 1 metre. And baby blue, you're getting 1 metre. So that's a whopping 8 metres of fabric plus thread. Yes. This is a massive bundle. Now, again, this is from the dashwood, same dashwood range. Look, if I can just show you. They were your two different dashwood colourways that we had for this fabric. And so now we've gone with the lighter colourways over here, which was very popular. We've put it with maize there. But then you see, do you remember we had those beautiful mountains and then we had the mountain outline? That's what we've got there. That's your mountain outline fabric, which put that way, fabulous, put that way, just different textures coming through. And then you've got your spot on, you've got your green in there, and then look at that. Look at that lovely linear there. So $73.45 for all of that. This is a massive bundle here, 8 metres of fabric. It's a whopper. Now, The lady that created the one behind us that we've all been admiring all morning, brand new guest, it's Jenni Smith. Hello. How are you?
I'm very good, thank
you. Now, welcome. I don't know really how to introduce you because you're so good at so many things. So I don't know whether to say you're a quilter, but you're also a stunning dressmaker, as seen here.
Yes.
Give us a quick twirl because this is also beautiful.
Pretty at the back is this one.
Yeah. So hang on, we've got a talented quilter, talented dressmaker, pattern designer as well.
Yes.
Should we throw that into the mix? Okay, is it quicker to say what don't you do with fabric?
Well, I just find that I love doing everything, so I can't really concentrate on one skill. I love quilting, especially in the winter. I always like to have a quilt project on the go. I love making my own clothes. I love teaching at my studio. And, yeah, we've just started to bring out some dressmaking patterns as well. So a bit of everything.
Very exciting. And because of that, a lot of you that came to the Great British Sewing Bee Live will have met you as one of our guests in the demo theatre there. And you did a cracking demonstration. So this is something that you're comfortable and happy with?
Yes. Yes, I think so.
Once we get going, I'll ask you again.
That'll be fine.
Now, this quote here, intermediate. Is that right?
It is, yes. That's what it says in the book. I think there's some simple piecing in it, actually, as I'll go through the different blocks. But there's just a little couple of juicy bits, as you call them, in there as well, which are just going to bring people's skills up to the next level.
So if you are an adventurous beginner, then this is a lovely step up to that intermediate.
Yes, and it's not a huge quilt, so again, I think it's not overwhelming in that sense, so it's achievable.
But you get 8 metres of fabric, do you use all of it?
No, there's definitely some leftover to play with, and you could break it down then into some nice cushions and use or even size up some of these centre blocks and have a go at experimenting with
it. Well, if you can imagine having a cushion out with that green bit as the central bit, almost sort of a cushion like that.
Yeah.
But then also you could have a cushion that was...
Yeah, or you could say, just with the star blocks as well, you could put some of those together, or just those four blocks again could work. So there's lots of different options with it, definitely.
Because this is what I always feel, you know, when we bring a quilt like this, if you are a beginner and you're looking to step up, sometimes a whole quilt is quite intimidating. Break it down into blocks, maybe do some cushions and then work your way up.
Yes.
What do we do then?
Okay. So, the first step that I'm going to talk through today, one of the main blocks in this quilt, about half of the blocks, is a snowball, which you can see here. And this begins life as a single square, and then we put the corners across so that it ends up looking like a more complicated block than it is. So it's quite a good trick. And also, this is the same block here, but because it's with the navy corners on, it looks different in this quilt. But I liked that because it makes the green really pop forward, actually, by using the blues on the blue for the other snowball.
Actually, that is a point to mention with this, isn't it? So this is the snowball here. This is a five-colour quilt, isn't it?
Yes.
You've got five different colours for this. So you can see where it gives you the different colours to use. But this is one that you said, actually, the putting together of the quilt itself sometimes can be a bit boring if you're just putting the same... You know, it's one of those switch off and just do mechanical things. But actually, with this, it was quite exciting.
It was.
Because it suddenly comes together with different colours coming through and you get a whole different look.
Yes. Finally, at the end, it's like a big jigsaw puzzle, really, because you can see these look very similar blocks, but actually these inserted triangles here, these triangles in a square, are set out in different orders. So when you're putting the final piece together, that's important because they go into the snowball blocks. So I sometimes get quite bored at the end of a quilt because all your blocks are the same and, you know, you think, right, I've just got to put this all together. Whereas with this, it was a really nice challenge at the end as well and really satisfying. I only got one wrong initially and had to unpick it and then
why we have on pickers. So that's the key then with this, is it?
To
absolutely follow the layout to a T.
Yes. And the instructions are clear and the cutting instructions are really clear as well. It's quite quick to cut out and actually, as you'll see as I do the demonstration, a lot of these blocks are achieved by sewing long strips together and then sub-cutting, so there isn't as much work as it seems when you first look at it.
I quite like that about a quilt.
Yes,
me too. A little cheeky...
cheeky
a few cheats along the way, definitely.
So where do we go? What do we start? How do we
so
do this?
So the first thing I was going to show is how we actually make the snowball blocks. So you cut your first squares in. You use two fabrics for the snowballs. So in this colourway, there's the crosshatch green and then the lovely trees. The actual snowball corners are the same fabric that right. you use on both. So on this quilt here, we used the navy birds, which is really lovely because actually the scale of the snowball corners was just about perfect that you get the birds flying off in different directions and it looked really, really nice.
And you can see in the book as well, here, that you can see very clearly different colours for the central bits, but these corners of the snowballs are the same. So already you're starting to see in the book, actually even the colours are showing you easily which ones to pick.
Yes, exactly. And you cut your width of fabric and subcut it into 2.5-inch squares for your snowball corners. So that's very easily done. And then the trick with these is basically just to take a ruler and a sharp pencil so you get a very, very nice line on them and just draw from corner to corner. I didn't worry about the direction of the fabric on the other side for these corners. So it's a case of lining that up corner to corner and doing yourself a line to follow. You don't have to do a continuous line. Sometimes that's a little bit harder. But as long as you've got enough to see when you're doing that row of stitching. So you do that on all four of your smaller squares, and then what you're doing is you're simply placing them in the corners of the background square.
Right sides together.
So right sides together, yes.
Excellent.
Okay, so you would be putting them like this, and what you have to just think about is that obviously you're going to be stitching from this corner to this corner, and then that's going to fold back on itself there.
That in itself feels like a little bit of a cheat, doesn't it? It looks like it should be more complicated than
yes,
that.
Yes, because the finished shape looks more complicated. Yes. So that's all that you need to do is stitch across there. Obviously, it's just getting that right. If you were to put this on incorrectly and you were to sew there, it wouldn't work.
No. You'd have a whole different look.
Yeah.
Yes.
So that goes on there like that. You don't have to pin, but if you are going to pin, as I've done here, I would pin this way so that my lines come in across, and that means I can keep that pin in until I stitch right up to it, obviously, mm-hmm. rather than putting the pin in long ways and then you've got to remove it much earlier on. They could shift slightly, so I've been overcautious on my first show and stitched everything
you
in
wait.
Place.
I bet by show three you'll be like, yeah, normally I'd pin this at home, but it's live TV, who cares? We can do this for speed.
Lucy is not a fan of pinning, but she's got slightly more experience than me. So that's what we're going to do, is stitch this. Now, in terms of, you don't need a quarter inch foot on at this point, because actually you need to be able to see the pencil line. That's
right.
All that you're worried about. So I quite like, I'll just unclip this, on my machine, I tend to use the clear foot, the applique foot.
Oh, okay.
Because it's got a nice open toe there, when you're stitching, you can see what the needle's up to and you can see your line a little bit clearer.
So as you're going along, so that you can see your line.
Yeah, because
in the middle there.
If you stick with the quarter inch foot on there, you can't really see what's going on underneath it.
You've got the guide on this quarter-inch foot.
Yeah, so either your regular foot, your A foot, on most machines, or I just quite like using that one for these snowball corners.
Now, some machines will call this your satin foot stitch, satin stitch foot, and a lot have metal either side to just slide over, but you're looking for that gap in the middle so that you can see. And that allows for that satin stitch to be put in there.
Yes.
But that's what you're looking for.
Yes.
There you go.
So I'll just show you that briefly, and then pop that underneath. So needle in.
Do you have to do any reverse stitches?
Not necessarily, really, because it's all going to be stitched into something else. It's just having a small stitch length. So when you set this machine, when you've got the quarter-inch foot on setting, it automatically sets the stitch length to about 1.8.
That's clever, isn't it? Not all machines do that, do they?
Yes, it knows. So that is clever. But what I've done on this, because I'm not using the quarter-inch foot at the minute, is I've just put my stitch length down to 2.0. So that should be absolutely fine to stitch this. So I just go along, then like I say, you can keep the pin in a little bit longer with it being that way, and you're just going right across and aiming for the corner.
Excellent.
And here's one I prepared earlier.
Yay!
I'm learning. Yeah. So there we go. So they've all been stitched down. And the next thing, which is a little, the only thing about snowball blocks is that they're a little bit wasteful. Because what we're cutting away now is excess fabric that isn't reused, unless you want to turn it into a scrappy pin cushion or, you know, I do save them because I don't like throwing anything away.
We've had guests that have drawn lines down there and stitched there and cut in the middle, so they've got little idly
piddly. Oh, really? Okay. Yeah. The little half-square triangles then, which you could definitely repurpose.
It depends how organised you are at the time, doesn't it? Because then
but it is nice because you do have... The pretty, what you're taking away, because you've got those contrasting fabrics that work well together. They are nice, so it does seem a little bit sad to get rid of them.
I have a box of little shapes like that. One day I'll order through and work it out. Anne in Cheshire says, thanks, Jenny. Info on the feet or any setup of the machine is brilliant information.
Okay.
Thank you, Anne. It's good to know. Always good to know.
So what I'm doing now is removing the excess corner. So I've put the stitch line onto the quarter inch line on the ruler, and then we just take them away.
And off they go.
And off they go, and then work your way around.
So when did you first start sewing?
I started sewing, I think, when I was about 8 or 9 years old. My grandpa used to build boats and trailer tents and caravans. And we had a sewing room kind of attached to the house where my mum and my nan used to help to stitch the upholstery as well. So
oh,
I think
wow.
it was just
It's just
around.
Always there.
Yeah, definitely. But more for myself, I started kind of cutting up clothes from the dressing up box and altering them, you know, from being about 8 upwards with my friend Laura. And then I learnt to quilt. I spent a year in Canada about 13 years ago now.
Oh, wow.
And... My son, who was one at the time, went to the YMCA for an hour a week because I didn't have any childcare. We were just there for a year.
Yeah.
And next to the YMCA, there was a quilting shop. So the first free hour I had to myself, I popped in there and they kind of took me under their wing. I think they thought, because I was an English girl and I didn't know how to quilt, they assumed that's what everybody did in England, I think. Oh. So they kind of took me under their wing and actually... A snowball, the first quilt I made was a king-size snowball quilt from one of Kaffe Fassett's museum books, and I pieced it all by hand and quilted it by hand. It's king-size. It's on my sofa at home. So I do like snowball
blocks. Well, in for a pound, I mean, go big or go home. And clearly, did it take you the year to do?
It took a long time, yeah, because they were smaller blocks than this. But I loved it, and it was a really nice, I think... I look back on that time really fondly, actually.
Oh, fab. So Pauline in East Riding of Yorkshire says, welcome, Jenny, loving your presenting skills, enjoying listening and watching you.
Oh, thank you, Pauline, that's very kind. So they've disappeared. They can be put in the little box for later, and that's how it looks then. And what you then have to do is simply... Oh,
do you
iron.
Want the iron?
Yeah.
Well,
we
have
got one. Oh, do you? Okay.
Only because I'm clumsy and otherwise I'm likely to burn myself. So we just tuck it away.
Okay.
And then as long as we don't iron it on the mat, we're all good.
I was liking, actually, look, when I was doing this the other day, I realised that kind of also creates a cool pattern
it
there,
does,
doesn't
it?
If you could then stitch them and... I don't know.
There's got to be
anyway.
A way. Do you want me to...
So, we just press those back.
So do you press, because I was always taught you press the stitches down like
you
that.
You can do, yeah.
And then just knock back.
And then like this. Yep.
Yeah. There we go.
And then your snowball is done.
Yay!
I think there are 17 of them in the quilt.
So lots of practice.
So lots of practice, but... they are reasonably quick, really, to come together because the cutting isn't complicated. They're just 6.5-inch squares, particularly if you've got the smaller 6.5-inch square ruler, and that's that. And then this is the opposite.
So this is, yeah, so in the book, it very clearly shows to have a darker fabric for one of them and a lighter one, but all of the corners the same. And so that's exactly what Jenny's done there.
Yeah, and in this one, actually, I've put... So the trees, you've got the dark trees, and they've got the darker corners on, but I felt when I was designing this quilt with the colours that there was enough going on, that in a way I wanted the stars to come forward and these central snowballs with the green to really pop. So I quite like, actually, how those blend in as well.
Oh,
so
I think
people
it's beautiful.
Can see how they feel with the bundles.
Absolutely stunning. So Canada has a lot to answer for, then.
Yeah, it looks a bit Canadian, these
it
nice
does,
trees,
doesn't it?
Don't
yeah.
They? And the colours that I used in the Kaffe Fassett snowball quilt were all... It was based on an archive quilt in the V&A collection, and it was all these gorgeous greens as well. So I do really love this colourway.
He's the only living artist to have an exhibition in the V&A.
Really?
Yeah.
Gosh,
oh, yeah.
I didn't know that.
Yeah.
Wonderful.
Oh, yeah.
Right, so... Those are done, and you just make more of them and
just
pop them
17.
To one
just
side.
Repeat 17 times.
And then we're going to come on to the next part, which is to start to construct the star blocks.
Okay. Now, again, beautifully set out in the book, but the key is to follow the colours.
Yes. Yes, so what I did originally is I wrote the list of the colourways in there, and when it's telling you, like it's saying, you know, lavender tonal, purple tonal, and everything, with a big equals, and then which fabric I was using, you know, dark trees, crosshatch, or what have you, and then you've got a reference each time. Because actually, with the darker quilt, the colours are more far removed from what's in the book, so once you get... it in your mind, it's fine, but you kind of just having it written down next year is helpful.
You've got that reference then, haven't you?
Yeah.
And this is what I see time and time again with our quilting guests, is the organisation is key.
Yes.
You know, don't, if, especially because you might not get a chance to sit down all in one go and do it all together, actually
yeah.
having it there, so you can step away and come back to it and not be lost.
Yes, but also if something does go slightly wrong, particularly with these, the star blocks, they're only narrow strips that you cut in. So off the width of fabric, you cut in, I think it was 1.5 inches. That will be right, yes. So if you do make an error in one colour, there's plenty of fabric. You know, you don't have to panic. It's not a write-off. You can just cut some more.
You're getting 8 metres
yes.
of fabric in
yeah.
here. And I think that's, we're always over generous with our fabrics. And it's so that you do get then some left over for other items or just so that actually it's not the end of the world. Because I hate kits where actually if you do
yeah.
slip up, that's it.
Yeah.
Forget it, game over. You know, your 73-45 is down the swanny. This means that you've got plenty left over to play with. And should you make an error, it's not the end of the world. Don't worry. 73-45, this is your country walks quilt. This is the colourway we're working with now. And as you say, yes, a little bit Canadian.
Yes. So the next point is then to start to make these squares, which these blocks go around the corner of all of the stars. So again, these are the same. You make lots of them. It's not too difficult to figure out. So it's a case of putting them right sides together and with a 1/4-inch seam this time, sewing them. I think it tells you to do them slightly shorter than the width of the fabric, but I thought it would take me longer to figure that out than actually just to sew them together.
Well, then you've also got that slip-up excess already
yeah.
done.
Yeah.
So it doesn't matter.
Yeah, and really, at that width, it's not like it's going to be much use for anything else. It's only a couple of inches extra, so
yeah.
I just stitched them along, which I didn't think I particularly need to show, So I've just got them here like
now,
this.
Now, one thing to mention is that if yesterday you managed to get the Stripology rulers, fabulous, because you've got that inch and a half marked and you can just cut through. Marie says, this new lady is good in shouty, shouty capitals. I hope she will be coming back. And that's from Marie in Cornwall.
Oh,
we hope she'll be coming back too.
Cornwall. That's where I go on my holidays every year.
Oh, where do you go?
We go to Harlyn Bay.
Oh, nice.
About 10 minutes from Padstow.
Very
so
nice.
I love it.
Yes.
So you sew these together and you press the seam in one direction.
Yes.
On the back, and that's fine. And then you go along and you subcut them into inch and a half pieces.
Okay.
So
and
I'll
again,
do a couple and then.
Instructions in the book for all of this cutting. And it is, look, it is, it's really, really clear. So the book details coming up on your screen. So whilst you do some cutting, I'll just show you here the book. So again, it's showing you all of your colours. So as Jenni said, just make sure that you know which colours are your colours. And then over here, here we go, you've got all of these. Now, this is just one of 12 projects. We only made you do one.
Yes.
And there was a look of, there were a lot of squares in there.
Just a mention as well, I pieced all of this with the Aurifil thread.
I didn't realise what a difference this made, and I had to ask you, why Aurifil?
Because it's gorgeous and lovely, and I mean, I've been helping out and working with Aurifil for 4 or 5 years, just volunteering, help them at Festival of Quilts and things, and people come up to me constantly saying, oh, it's changed my life, and you can't imagine that about a thread, but because it's so fine, it's all Egyptian cotton that's processed in Milan. I've been to the factory in Italy. It's just, there's no lint, there's no build-up. It's just a beautiful, beautiful thread to stitch with. And the thing with this is that in one of these small blocks here, you've got 32 blocks. So don't be intimidated by that. It's absolutely fine. But there are 32 individual pieces. And that's a lot of piecing, really. So the finer thread that you can use means that that's going to sit much nicer, and it's going to be simpler to press and to piece together.
I hadn't even thought of that. I kind of just, you know, Aurifil is pretty. I just thought it was just a really pretty thread. I didn't realise what a difference having that finer thread. And of course, you're not going to bung up your machine if it's lint-free.
No. And it's the orange spools that are the 50-weight thread.
Nice.
The other good thing about it as well is, like, on the smaller spools, I think, is there... Let's just have a little look. It's 200 metres on those, but on the larger spools, you get 1,300 metres, so that's a lot more thread than on a regular spool. So when you're filling your bobbin, when you're chain piecing a lot of squares, you don't have to refill it because it lasts you the entire quilt, really.
So this is your happy colours, 10 of those. We've only got a limited amount of this left. It's been incredibly popular. $33.95. There was quite a rush when we got the Aurifil because they've been waiting, and there it is.
I think people within the industry, you know, people who've been quilting with it love it and are converted. It's just kind of having that.
Is it one of those things that until you try it, you don't actually realise what you've been missing out on?
Yeah, and I was a bit sceptical, so I was like, how can it make a difference, really, the first time? And then we put it in our machine, me and my friend came, and we were like, oh, it sounds really nice. And it just feels differently, honestly. It is really, really nice.
Another message, Wendy in Essex says, welcome, Jenni. Brilliant explanations. Come back again soon, like you and Tash together.
Everybody's very nice.
Do you know what Aussies are? Did you meet many of them at the Great British
Show? I did, they were lovely. Really nice.
Always gorgeous. And so lovely when we actually get out to meet you as well.
Yeah.
So over 30 pieces.
32 pieces, but it's
32.
I'm not scared.
Let's not forget that too. No.
No, it's fine. Honestly, it comes together quickly. It's just, I think the point about it is you want a light thread in there, because otherwise it's just going to get heavier and heavier each piece, and you haven't even got to the quilting stage yet.
So these are the pieces that we've been working on. I say we. I mean, it's always like, you know, throw away. This bit here.
Yes.
So
basically, all I've done is I would go along this entire strip and subcut, and actually I'd be comfortable enough to layer that up. If I'd done two of these, I would put that on top and subcut those, because you're still only going through single fabric. And then because your seams are already pressed, you then simply switch them around to create that square there. Mm-hmm. And magically, your seams are already going in opposite directions anyway.
This was a revolution for me when I realised that you could kind of interlock seams. And I remember having a chat with a lady on Facebook about it. She's like, how have you suddenly gone from having wonky joins to ones that actually piece together? And it's just doing this.
The thing about quilting is there's a process, isn't there? You know, you do have to cut. If you cut accurately, and you probably spend as much time pressing as you do on the machine in reality, but it always makes the next step much easier and you get better results. You can't really skip that stage. You couldn't finger press this. There's a point a bit later where you can finger press to do these triangles in the square. But I think, you know, it is an important stage. And my dressmaking teacher, Anne Labbury, said to me that a well-pressed seam doesn't cast a shadow. So that's a good way of thinking about it. Because I obviously always press it on the wrong side and press the stitch in, but then I do always flip over to the right side and get the toe of the iron in there. And when it is pressed nice and flat, you can see, you know, it doesn't cast a shadow.
So top,
quite an easy thing to remember.
Tip. Keep them coming. I'm going to leave you to sew those together.
Okay.
Chain piecing? Is that the way?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Because a lot of you want to see this fabric, so I'm going to leave you to sew that.
Okay.
I'm going over there to look at fabric. Oh, yeah. Now, the Country Walks is over here. This is the one that we've been working with today. 8 metres in total. This is a whopping kit. You're going to have a lot left over. You're going to have a lot to play with. But as soon as you get a quilt that calls for 5 different shades, you're going to use a lot of fabric. And that's what we've put in. So these are your Dashwood fabrics here. Now, you see, on its side, it looks completely different, doesn't it, to the mountain range, the when you spin it. A lovely, lovely one. Now, we've put that with your spot on and your green, and then you've got that linear in there. That linear, of course, just makes it a bit more earthy because it's not a straight, straight line. It's a bit more organic. But then you've also got in there the trees, hence the country walks, and then you've got that maize colour in there as well. So £73.45. It's a lighter palette, more pastely, WWGC03, but that's 2 Dashwood fabrics in there. If you're a Dashwood fan, maybe go for that one. Now, apple of my eye is this one here. This is organic cotton, the apple fabric here. 100% organic cotton. Big, bold, beautiful prints. Lots of fun. It's a bit retro-y, isn't it? But just lots and lots of fun. So it sits really nicely. And what you're seeing here is that you've got a big version of the dandelion that we've also put in. So you've got that continuity discreetly. And I love that. So you've got that blue there that's pulled into there, but with that that option there. And then because you've got the spots in there, we've given you the spot on. But again, 8 metres of fabric, a whopper. And thread. Don't forget your thread. We've popped that in. Of course, if you want to use your Aurifil, grab that as well today. Now, the last one, which is the beautiful one behind Jenni, and it is absolutely exquisite. This is a standout quilt, absolutely stunning. But just look at the colourways before you even start with your Dashwood fabrics. Wow. Yeah, this is the most popular kit. I'm not surprised. When you see it made up, just exquisite. QQGC00. Now, the Dashwood fabrics that you're getting with this one, and it's a metre of each, they're your trees. It's kind of like a midnight walk, isn't it, in your deep forest. And then you get the birds. And they swoop around all over the place. But as Jenni said, you know, when she was making these, they fit really nicely into the corners of those snowballs. She used those for the corners of the snowball blocks, and you'd get a swoop and a bit of bird in that very nicely. And, of course, your thread, don't forget your thread. You've got that as well. So £69.95 for that for a whopping 8 metres. 8 whole metres. Now, the one that we're using is the Country Walks. Beautiful. Do you want these pressed?
Yes, we can press those. That'd be good. Is this health and safety?
it saves us dancing.
All
really.
Right, okay.
This is easy as that. It's just, you know.
I'll just do this last one.
And it saves a little bit of time as well.
Yeah, so these are absolutely fine to fold and chain piece as you go without having to pin. They come together absolutely fine.
And if it doesn't look like the chess piece checkerboard to start off with, remember that you've got that seam allowance, haven't you, in there to play with. Because that's where I often panic, Jenni, because I'm still learning.
Yeah.
I would look at that and go, it's wrong. Hang on, it's not quite right.
Yeah.
Yeah, go on. I can do that.
And then we've got the corners. So then the next part to start to think about, that the centre block here is exactly the same. That's a case of, again, you're using this accent fabric here, which appears a lot. So this has already been on the corners of some of the snowballs, and then it's in the squares here as well. So you use that, and in this kit, you could change it up and have the green potentially as the colour in the stars, which really comes forward. But this was my favourite. I thought that worked really, really well. Just for this centre square, you're obviously making less of those. You sew these two long strips just as you did here, and then subcut and piece them. So it's exactly the same dimensions as that one. You just need fewer of them.
Excellent.
So I can just quickly cut that one, and then we can make that up. And we've got a minute. And then I'm going to move on to talk about a triangle in a square.
Okay. Triangle in a square.
Yes. And to me, this is everything we've done so far. Snowballs, strip piecing, subcutting is fine for beginners and whatever level you're at, I think. I guess, in a way, because you're working with smaller dimensions, that's something else that's good, another skill to build. But I think the reason that in the book they've built this as intermediate is because of this part here.
Yeah, now, this is it. So this is your triangles in a square. Is that right?
Yes. And basically, there are templates in the book.
Phew.
So, they're here. Okay. And it tells you quite clearly which ones you have to cut. And so what you can do, you can obviously, first of all, initially, you can trace, if you wanted to, you can first of all trace that shape. So I just use some regular tracing paper for that. Or you can put them, make them straight onto template plastic if you've got that. Or if you haven't got template plastic, you can cut the side off a strawberry or a plum carton and use that because you always get a big... For this size of template, actually, it fits just fine. So you can also do that.
And it's helping get you 5 a day, which is never a bad thing. Or have they upped it to 7 a day now?
Oh, I don't know.
It's like, come on.
I don't think I can manage 7. No. 5, just about. Or you can... Then I just transferred them onto card from here, because you can see this more clearly. When I was making the quilt behind, the fabrics are dark, so when you're drawing the lines to then subcut these shapes, if it's a see-through template, it's harder to see. See-through templates have their place when you're fussy cutting. If you're trying to get a particular part of a design, obviously in that shape, then you can. It's clear you can put it on top. You can see and cut round it. But for this quilt, you don't need to do that. So I found it easy just to work with them then on card.
Okay.
So once they're made like this. So if you imagine this is this part here, and then you cut two of these for each blocks, which you're then essentially sewing on either side. So that would be...
There we go. Let's use your... There
yeah,
we go.
Like that.
There we are.
So the only... there are different ways to do this. When you look on... Some people would foundation paper piece this, like for flying geese. But the book and the template and how it comes is that you cut them like this, and I'll show you that in a moment, and then it's how you stitch them together, because when you line it up like this, it doesn't... If you if you have this edge flush here, then it's not going to be correct when you open it out.
Right.
So the trick is having a slight quarter of an inch overlap there, which means it doesn't quite meet
if
at the bottom there.
If I am that adventurous beginner that's taking a step up, can I mark that quarter of an inch on my template and transfer that mark onto my fabric so that I'm absolutely sure?
Yes, and you can, of course. And I tried different things. I thought, I wonder if I find out the centre point here and the centre point there. If that's where it works, it doesn't.
So, don't do that. So don't do that. No.
But yes, but I think as well, I think once you get your eye in on doing this, it's fine. And actually, when you then piece the blocks together, there's a little room for manoeuvre. So okay. I wouldn't get too stressed about it. I just think that's the one point. You know, they are a trickier block just for that simple reason. Like in half square triangles, you know, your corners meet when you're stitching them together. So it's just getting that offset right. Some templates would have a more complicated shape. They would take this corner off down here, so that would line up. Mm. But that means it's also then more laborious to cut out. So it's a kind of balance between, you know, do you do that and take longer cutting it out, or do you just get used to this measurement here? And I'll show how to do it. It's not terrible, but I think that's why this is an intermediate pattern.
Okay. So it is, if your eye isn't in there, then just mark it and transfer those marks.
Yes.
But because this is it, you know, so many quilters, they can they call it eyeballing. Oh, I can eyeball a quarter of an inch.
Yeah.
And I'm sure that it's basically burnt onto your retina, this quarter of an inch, because that's what you use. Now, if you would like the template plastic that Jenni was just talking about, here it is, £2.95, same as your P&P. Whilst you've got that basket open, pop it in. Only a limited stock of this. We did have this on the other day, so a lot of you got it then. But if you haven't grabbed it, FZGQ75. Whilst we're talking about limited things, the happy colours in your Aurifil, lots of you going for that. Now, this is what you've recommended because it's a finer thread.
Yes.
No lint. It's not going to bang up your machine. But also, if you're working a really intricate piece like this with 32 pieces in one block, get yourself a nice fine thread.
Yeah.
Happy colours. She doesn't look the happiest.
But you will be happy when
But you will
use
be happy
it.
When yeah. you get it.
Yeah.
I love things like that. The juxtaposition just makes me
it
giggle.
It must be hard to come up with names for all the collections all the time. You know, with threads and fabrics and things, I always think, because there's so much choice out there, isn't there, for people
to choose. It's kind of when it's narrowed down, it's easier.
Yeah.
And we used to play, I worked as a dresser for the Royal Shakespeare Company, and there was this older guy, Roy, and I, and when you work on the histories, you have great long gaps in between having to change people's clothes. So we used to play Scrabble. But instead, we used to just think of a theme. We'd have themed Scrabble.
Okay.
So it all had to be around one theme, which was fine until I think one day we did swear words and then realised that actually everybody looks at Scrabble boards. We're like, no, quick, put them away. And we didn't do that again. Right, where are we?
So we are cutting the centre parts of these triangles in a square. And as you can see, it's easier with the card template for me than a clear template, just to see the lines. So I would put this on the wrong side of the fabric, and then what I prefer to do is to make a line. And as long as you've got a sew line pencil, or if you've got a regular pencil, just make sure that it's sharp, because if you've got a blunt tip, then actually that's going to make your line a little bit wider,
it's
and you've only
accuracy,
you haven't got a lot of room
it?
To
yeah.
play with when you're quilting. You don't need to draw a continuous line because this is just a cutting line, so you don't have to, you know, be pressing too hard on the fabric. It's just making three or four smaller marks so that you know you then have a line to follow, and then you can flip it and mark the other way. I think this ends up quicker than trying to each time put the ruler on top without marking the line and worry that this is going to slide.
Can I double my fabric up?
Yes, so what I would do is I would mark it on the single one, so you've got a couple going along like this. So you only need to mark up one, but mm-hmm. then what you can do is get your other widths of the other strips that you need in this, and you need different colours, you see, because this is the centre part.
So you've got the lichen there and
the puzzle at the end, they come together like that. So once you've actually marked it up, then it's absolutely fine to layer all three, really, if you wanted to, You could put that one underneath as well because it's still only three layers of fabric. So let's do that. You do need slightly different quantities of these, so just check you don't need to cut all of them in each fabric. But if you were to put them together like that, and then you can just... I missed that one like there. I need to just come along a little bit.
Everyone loves a time-saving tip. You know, it's the one thing that you can't buy, isn't it?
Yeah, and then you would just line up between your dashes like so and cut and then just change direction like that. So then you've got your centre parts of the triangle and the squares ready, so you can pop those into little piles. And then the other one is, it comes out of the same width is the ends here.
Right.
These are all the same colour because these create the points in the star.
Okay.
So that's essentially what you're cutting out. When I did this quilt, they were out of the solid blue. So I haven't...
Which one have you allocated for this?
Actually, I've just... So we didn't need that one. So this would be this now.
Nobody saw. It's fine. Nobody noticed.
But it's the same width, like I say. So with this, again, if you're marking it up, you'd be marking it up on the wrong side. So you have to have a certain amount, half of them this orientation and half that orientation, so that they fit into the either side. Like this.
Oh, so you can't just do them upside down and tessellate them that way?
Well, on a solid fabric, you can. So right. I did on that one because I don't think you would honestly be able to tell which is the right or the wrong side of the blue. But obviously on this one, you can't. So you've got to cut half of them in one direction and then flip it and cut them the other way. So as long as you do half and half, that's fine. And again, you can just pencil those lines on, cut them and layer them up, because you obviously need more of these. You need every point of the star. So there's quite a few of those. I can't quite recall. 72 of those to cut.
One or 72. Yeah, excellent.
Okay.
So there's a bit of cutting to get done for this, isn't there?
And then what you have to just do is, on these, it's putting one side on first. I think I've possibly pinned one, but anyway, we'll just... Putting this side on first, so I've got that top just coming over slightly there, and we'll stitch that, and then you have to finger press or press that back before you add the second side on, which means that it then ends up like so.
Now, again, this is a moment where I would say, oh, I've done it wrong, because... No, that's your seam allowance, isn't it? So you're going to get that perfect point there.
Yes, and really what you should have just about here is sufficient seam allowance for them when they're stitched into your corner blocks there as
well. Which is how you got, look at that, perfect. Perfect, it does look amazing. And then again, that's your quarter inch there to then make it into that full block. All instructions are... Hang on, where is the book? Here we go. All instructions in the book. Now, perhaps if I get it the right way around. This is one of 12. So we've got 10 minutes left. And that's all we've got left. But look, you've got 12 different projects in here, ranging from beginner through to advanced. So you've got templates. There we go. Jenni, I've only got 6 minutes left with you.
So I've just stitched down that side there. So you can then press that back.
I can do that for you. I can do that. That
well,
will help.
I was finger pressing them because I think it's enough. Because then you simply add in this one on. And the second one is easier because you've then got that guide. If that's the same distance there and you line that side up, that comes together much easier. So then you create those centre of the stars with these. Like so, and then you'd have that in the middle.
Oh, nice.
And you bring it together, and then it's like going back to a basic nine patching quilting, in a sense that you would stitch your top three rows together. your middle three rows, your bottom rows. On the top...
Is that why it's called a nine patch, just because of how it's sewn together?
Well, there's nine.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, in my head, yeah. Like, that's a kind of traditional patchwork block, isn't it? So I pressed those seams outwards.
Yes.
The middle one, which is quite bulky, inwards, and then the opposites there, just to get that to sit nice and flat.
So hang on, let's have outwards, inwards,
outwards. Yes.
The colourways work nicely, don't they, together?
Yeah, it's lovely.
I don't normally go for yellows, but I really like this. I tell you what, producer Hannah would love this. She'd be all over this.
Really?
With the oranges and yellows, that's absolutely her thing. For me, this is the showstopper. Look at that.
And just that's it, stunning. Though. Once you've got snowballs and your stars, like I said, it's just then looking at these, concentrating when you're putting these triangles in the squares so you get this balance right, because as they all come together, these points bleed into the snowballs to create these lovely diamond shapes.
Okay.
So that's why they're different as you go along, basically.
So here, you've got the trees that are going to work into there.
Yes.
And then, of course, because you've got that corner up there, it's then going to give you that...
Yes.
Brilliant.
So you'll see, when you're piecing it together, you'll see if you go wrong, it's like double-checking, triple-checking. And then in terms of the quilting, I'd go pretty simple because I think it's a busy quilt. There's a lot going on. So I just, once I'd added on the borders, which are really quick and easy, I just quilted down through my centre points of the snowballs in both directions. And to me, I felt like that was enough, really.
Yeah.
There's still quilting, you know, for my teacher taught me that you should probably have a bit of quilting for about every size of your fist as you go around a quilt. But modern waddings say, you know, you can quilt up to 10 inches apart. So.
But that depends on your wadding, doesn't
yes.
it? I mean, we
yeah.
had one yesterday that you could quilt from 1/4 inch up to 3.5 inches.
Oh, okay.
And that was what it said. Check your wadding. Check what you're putting on there so that you can tell. I mean, there's also, you could, if you wanted to go crazy, in the middle of those green patches, you could do a central feature or something.
Yeah.
Depends. What I'm learning very much is that actually the patchwork is just half your quilt. By the time that you come to quilt, that can be a whole other art form as well.
Yeah, and the one in the book is free motion quilted actually.
Oh, wow.
All over. Which does look really pretty as well.
Hang on. It's right at the back, isn't it? 57.
Yes. So there's just one picture of it.
Oh, there you go. So that's you can see the quilting on there. Very intricate.
So it looks like it's not densely free motion quilted. But that looks pretty as well.
And isn't it different in the different colours?
Yeah, really
they
different.
They just
yeah.
look so different. So you've got that in your lavenders and your greens, that in a real standout colour. And then you've got your more muted tones here.
I love this little bit as well, like the details here, like you see the stars, but then this, I really liked this individually as...
like a lozenge, isn't
yeah.
it, through there?
Yeah, there was one on the table runners that Lucy did last week, I think, that was really pretty as well.
So lots to look at in
yeah.
this quilt. It's one that's going to keep your eye for an awfully long time. Jenni, thank you
you're welcome.
So much. Now, you're going to come back in an hour. Well, we hope you're going to come back.
We
haven't scared you off too much. You'll be back in an hour.
Yes.
Foundation paper piecing.
Yes. And I was thinking if someone had was saying, coming up next, foundation paper piecing to me, and I was sitting at home about a year ago, I would have probably been thinking, right, I'll go and have an early lunch now.
But
switch
don't.
Over, but
don't.
Because it's a reasonably new skill to me. And I think it's a fantastic skill to have. There are so many new quilts coming out and cushions and patterns that are foundation paper piece that you don't really want to miss out on that. And I think this cushion set that we're doing, there's two of them. And for me, I think once you've done a project twice, you've kind of cracked it. And I did it about 6 months ago, left it, and then came back and made these cushions, and I wasn't scared. So I just think it's something you've got to stick with and just keep... Be brave.
So you're going to demystify
yes,
foundation paper piecing in an hour's time.
Yes.
Thank you so
All right,
much.
Thank you.
Brilliant first show. Thank you. It's Jenni Smith, everybody. Now I'm going to take these and go look at some fabric.
All right, thank you.
See you in a bit. Go and grab a cup of tea.
Okay.
Right. Okay. Over here we have, this is the book that it came from. Oh, do you want to have a look? Let's have a look at the quilt, actually, as the details are on the screen for that. Let's go with that. So your deep forest is this one here.
I'll do a little dance for you. These are the colourways. Woo! That's why that quilt is really bright and vibrant. Look at those colours. Absolutely stunning. And then look, in here, this is your dashwood fabric that we've matched in with it. So bright and vibrant and 8 metres and your thread. Hello, from the 70. That's a whopping great big bundle just right there. Now, the book that it came out of is your Lap and Throw Quilts book, this one here. And this is, what, $12.95, I want to say? So you've got... oh, you need to check out. Okay, been very, very busy on this. £12.95, 12 projects in there. So it's a smidge over £1 a project. So 12 ranging from beginner through to advanced. So whichever level you're at, there's something in there for you. Now, the Aurifil, you need to check this out as well. Jenni said, absolutely. In something as intricate as this quilt that we've just done with 32 pieces in one block, then you need your happy colours because this is a lighter thread, no lint. It doesn't mess up your machine, doesn't block up your machine. And it's just very, very beautiful to use on your quilts. Gorgeous colours and actually a lovely luster to it as well. Now, two more combinations for you to take a look at as well. This is your apple. Now, the apple, this fabric and this fabric... organic cotton, beautiful organic cotton. And you can just see there, you've got that big dandelion there and the dandelion is echoed in that fabric choice there. And then we've matched those, the vibrant green and orange there, that and given you orange thread and your blues. So there, a bit more retro, love that, $75.95. Then the last option brings that dashwood fabric again, but this time in a more muted, cooler tone, actually. It's a quieter one, but it's gentler with the colours. And there you go, you've got all of that. And again, 8 metres of fabric, $73.45 with these. But you've got, you've got these lovely light pale greens and that yellow in there. So it's restful, it's peaceful, slightly cooler palette. $73.45, WWGC03. That is your code for that one. So, which one to go for? Which is the most popular? Is that one that we've been working with. Oh, the Country Walk. Hey, but you do need to check out your baskets. Please don't miss out on this. If you've absolutely loved what you've seen this morning, please check out your baskets. Make sure that you've got it. Thank you. Fabulous new guest, Jenni Smith. She'll be back in an hour. I'm back next with some Kaffe.
Join us on Facebook. Simply search for The Sewing Quarter and like our page for the latest news and more. There are many ways you can watch Sewing Quarter. We are live every day on Freeview Channel 78 and online at sewingquarter.com from 8 a.m. till 12 noon. But if you've missed a show, don't worry. There are two easy ways to catch up. The first is through our website, www.sewingquarter.com, where we repeat that morning's shows throughout the day. On the homepage, you'll see our video stream. Click on the video to hear sound and see a list of the products that we have shown in that day's shows. The second way to catch up is on our YouTube channel. All our shows are kept on YouTube, so if you buy a product and want to see the demonstration again, you can. Go to www.youtube.com/sewingquarter, where you'll find all our shows listed by date. Select your preferred date. Then, using the description beneath the video, jump to the hour you want to watch. Then you can pause, rewind, play, and skip your way to the bits that you want to watch again. Only on Sewing Quarter, Freeview Channel 78.
Did you know there are multiple ways you can contact us, even if it's just to ask a question? Our friendly team are always on standby. You can call our customer service team at 0800 112 4433, email us at help@sewingquarter.com, visit our Facebook page, follow us on Instagram, follow us on Twitter at Sewing Quarter, and even message us through our website and our presenters will answer your questions live on air.
By popular demand, the under £15 hour is back. For one fun-filled hour, we'll be bringing you a plethora of sewing tools, accessories, gadgets, and haberdashery essentials, all at an affordable price. This show promises to be a fast and furious showcase of great products that you never realised you needed until you saw them in action. So join us on Thursday, the 5th of October at 9 a.m. and get ready to restock your sewing studio, only on Sewing Quarter, Freeview Channel 78.
Welcome back. Now, this hour is all about Kaffe. Actually, we've got a sneaky hedgehog in there as well. We'll talk about that in a second. Now, we've got, well, one of my favourites is a pre-cut pack. I love the fact that you get the diversity of a complete range without the cost of having to buy a huge amount of it, but you still get those snippets of your favourite fabrics. And that's what we've got for you for Kaffe. We've got three fabulous charm packs. So these are 42 pieces here. It's a 5-inch charm pack, so it's going to give you a 4.5-inch finished square. But just look at the variety in here. This is the lipstick range. This is just a little smorgasbord of the kind of colourways that you're getting. It's Kaffe, you get all the colours. What can I say? And now that's just a few here and there. But these are your reds and your pinks and your oranges, all going on in there. All sorts. I mean, there's 42 pieces in here. Some are repeats, but still, look at that. Just fab. And because of how heavily patterned Kaffe's work is, then it's like you get 42 different pieces, to be honest. Look at that. Isn't that fabulous? So if you love Kaffe, and quite frankly, who doesn't? Look at that. I mean, that's just a little snippet of the sort of thing that you could be working with here. Maybe you want to put through some planes and really make those pops. Maybe you just love that denseness of the colour. But it's $17.95 for 42 5-inch pieces of Kaffe. Oh, yes. It won't come to you all laid out like that. That's only because I've had a little play. You'll get it like this. Hooray! And when I get one like this, it's that excitement of how am I going to work with this? How am I going to play with this? What am I going to be creating with all of this? Under £20 for 42 pre-cut pieces of Kaffe Fassett fabric in your lipstick charm pack. Woo, beautiful. Now, I'm going to go blue next. Now, this is called Island. Again, let me set out a few of these for you. Now, these are just as they're coming off the packet. They're not in any particular order. So I just like, ooh, that's a nice one. I like to add in that just that little random feel. It's lovely, isn't it? So, again, a lot of these inspired by nature, as, you know, a lot of Kaffe's work is. But you're getting in here, you're getting your greens, your browns, your pinks. It's all coming through. And there you go. So you get some repeats, but again, it doesn't ever feel like it. Just brilliant. Look at these colours. And of course, the beauty of Kaffe is that you get all the colours. And so you don't have to just stick with just having the blues. You know, you'll see that in the other collections, you've got all these colours too. So you can get them and you can mix them through. Absolutely you can. But you get polka dots, you get florals. It is under £20, which for basically you can make a beautiful patchwork Kaffe something is a fabulous price. There you go. That just gives you a little idea of what you're getting
but you're getting 42 pieces, 42 pre-cuts. The joy of the pre-cut, of course, is that it saves you time. All you have to do is get on and make and really have fun making. Get creative, it's there. Maybe you want to do a whopping great big quilt and you need to buy a couple, then do that. It's under £20. It's £17.95, like seriously under £20. Yeah. Oh, look at that. That looks stunning, doesn't it? Absolutely glorious. £17.95. Brilliant. Now, the last one is a citrus one. Oh, and it's super charming. I'm going to have to move these across a little bit. Now, citrus is next. When I get... Oh, it's just disrupted all my... all my little setup there. Sorry. I didn't plan the desk, did I? I was doing so well and I've just let myself down. I've let the world down. Look at that. The quilting world is anxious. There you go. It's angry. Angry quilters everywhere. Right, that's only so that I've got... You'll forgive me, but it's just so that I've got room to... Well, I hope you will anyway. A bit sad if you don't. this is your... Hey, look at these. This is your citrus. Have we got root? Have I got enough root? Look at these colours coming through. Woohoo! Loving these. Oh, look at that. Isn't that a stunner? Now, that's... So, these collections, when we had Kaffe on the show a little while ago, he works with two other designers. There's his husband, Brandon Mabley. Or does he pronounce it Mabley? And he designs with him, and also a third guy called Philip Jacobs, who is an incredible designer. Now that's Philip Jacobs' work, but he hates working with colour, so Kaffe takes over the colour. Kaffe does all the colour, and together he calls themselves he says that they're like the three musketeers of the quilting world, because it just all works together. Producer Paul is quite excited about the fact that he could have 42 pocket squares or Nitro, as he's now calling himself off the earlier show, or as we're now going to call him. But just look at these different designs and colours. Look at this one. Woo! All sorts coming through here. This is your citrus. I mean, wow, talk about this could be warm autumnal colours. Oh, if you got some of those autumn colours that we had on the shows yesterday for you, then that would work through, wouldn't it? An absolute treat. What a stunning collection. Yeah. Oh, yeah. I don't know which is my favourite. Producer Paul, do you have a favourite out of these colours? Look at all of that. I've got to clear these up now, haven't I? Although, actually, saying that, okay, I've now got Kaffe by the half metre. This is the joy of today's show. It is all about your Kaffe. But actually, maybe you want to back in Kaffe as well. I don't know about you, but I really love a quilt where you can turn a top edge over and you get something beautiful on the back as well. So, just going to throw it out there. Maybe if you're going for the lipstick, how about having a squiggle on the back. Okay, this is where I always get upset, because it's called mauve squiggle and I can't see any mauve in there. But that is the right name for it. I did check, I did query it. So this is called mauve squiggle. It's not mauve, it's pink and orange. But that's what it is. Basically, just double check the picture for the one that you think that you're getting. £6.95 per half a metre. What a great price for Kaffe Fassett by the half metre. Which means that you can have that as the backing for your quilt. You could have all of these beautiful lipstick colours here, and then you could back it in that. Hello? Yes, please. That would be amazing. By the half metre. Yes, please. Kaffe Fassett by the half metre. That's not always readily available. It is here, because there it is. What a stunner. What a absolute stunner. Now, the next one that I'm going to show you is paint pots in orange or yellow. Okay. And I'm going to say that this would look... Well, actually, it would look fab either with your lipstick or with your citrus. Can I move the Christmas tree? It's in my way. There we go. Yeah, what about that? So maybe you want that as your backing quilt. Maybe you want to make that variety of your charm pack go even further by mixing new colours through. Why not? It's up to you. It's your quilt. Maybe that's going to be the backing of a cushion. Maybe you're going to make loads of cushions with your charm packs. And there you have maybe the backs of your cushion. Maybe the back of your quilt. Maybe you just love that fabric and you've got an idea for that all by itself. Maybe you're going to make a dress out of it. I don't know. I don't know. I don't know. Ooh, actually, do you know what, Producer Paul? We've got lots here that's going to go with that citrus one. But also, ooh, okay. Now this is, I've got to be careful how I say this, raked in blue. Raked kaffe in algae. And I'm not quite sure where to put this. I don't know whether to put it here with the lipstick, because look, you've got some of these oranges. And yeah, part of me is like, yeah, that works. But then also with the citrus, yeah, I'm gonna leave it with the citrus over there. I like that over there. But then I also love, the gerbera. Now here's your gerbera. This is, now this is just crying out to be made into a dress, wouldn't it? Like that dress that Jenni had on earlier. Could you imagine that in a gerbera? Be amazing. This is Sunshine Gerbera, $6.95 per half a metre. Yes, yes, yes. I'm going to pop that down there. Yes. Now, maybe you want, this is an eye-catching squiggle. Check out the squiggle here. Hee-hee, squiggling red. But isn't it just such a different look? The red and the blue together. Now that's the same colourways as the algae, the raked algae. $6.95 per half a metre. It's up to you how much you want. What do you want, Producer Paul? Which ones do you want? He can't decide. There's almost too much choice, isn't there? Okay, let's have a look at the raked again. This time in blue. Cobalt blue. Well, I know where this one's going. Now, you see, this is where we all see different things. So whether you see the sea, whether you see fields, whether you see yarn rolled, everybody sees something different. So $6.95, that is your cobalt raked fabric. And I'm going to put that down there with the greens. Oh, no, it's got to be, look, that looks lovely with, actually, and I'm going to put it over here because then it's not going to fall off the edge of the desk. Ha-ha. There you go. So maybe you want that as your backing fabric for your green kaffe quilt. Looks gorgeous. Now, this is why I always get this is pink squiggle, and it has mauve in it, which is why I always think it's the mauve one. It's not. The pink squiggle is the pink that is squiggly. I didn't name these. $6.95, VMRW 78. And I would put that with, I'm going to put that down the centre there. Because I think that you could use that with the greens, but I also think that you could use it with the lipsticks. There you go. So I'm going to pop that down the middle there. This desk now looks like the most amazing, great big patchwork of everything, doesn't it? Oh, now. This is my favourite. This is the magenta gerbera. Yeah, no, okay. I don't want the yellow and blue now as a dress. I want hot pink and orange. Yes, yes, yes. Please. $6.95. For your Kaffe Fassett magenta gerbera. Love the clash of those colours. Just works so beautifully. I'm going to put that down with the lipstick ones over here. Yeah. Oh, I love how this desk is looking. It is a Kaffe Fassett desk. Look at it. Oh, it's just beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. Now, here we go. Raked again. Only a few more by the half metre. This is your raked again. Here it is. Now this is pumpkin, very apt. Now we're into October. So this is your raked in pumpkin. Works really well with the gerbera. But also, if I show you, if you want to pop this down here, look at it with the citrus. Mmm. Yeah, yeah. I'm rather enjoying that. Yes. Ooh. Oh, gorgeous. But then equally, I'm going to move it again. Down there, if you want to work it through with your gerbera, please do so. Hey, look, it's up to you. Two more fabrics by the half metre. Let's have a look. This is your paint pots. And this is your paint pots in orange. So that when you're looking at these, the paint pots in orange, it's the colours of the actual round pots that's determining, yeah. And that's, again, £6.95. So all of these, £6.95 by the half metre. And I'm popping that in between the lipstick and the green, because your green one over here, which is your island, has got all of your purples in. But you see, you've also got the purples over here in your lipstick. Oh, mix and match and mingle them. I kind of like this. Can we just take a photo and pretend it was one big quilt? Yeah. Now, the last one to look at this morning in terms of half metres, Squiggling Blue. Is it called Squiggling Blue? Oh, finally a name that I understand. Squiggling Blue. Squiggling Green? Oh, man. I thought I got it right. Squiggling Green. Are you tutting, cameraman Tim? Tutting and shaking your head in a despairing way at me. What would you have called it? Oh, we wouldn't have called it anything. Yeah. Now, here we go. I'm going to pop that. He would have called it... producer Paul, a.k.a. Nitro, as he would like to know, would have called it Splatter. Blue Splatter on green. I think that we should have an alternative naming committee. Now, I'm loving that with the island, but equally, if you look over here at your citrus, you've got those greens coming through too. Nice. I just love this desk. Look at that. Oh, apart from that's going to annoy me. There we go. That just makes me happy. Yeah. This is heaven. This is absolute heaven, isn't it? Look at this. Now for something completely different. Here we go, over here. Ah, there's our hedgehog. Now, for anybody watching yesterday, our hedgehog is Joe Carter's latest creation. We brought loads to wear for you because we know that her things really, really sell out very fast. We have a handful of these left. So if you couldn't watch yesterday, you can always catch up again on YouTube. Just put in sewing quarter and yesterday's date and it will come up with a tutorial. But you can grab him today. There is enough fabric in there to make two hedgehogs. So $17.95 gets your hedgerow hedgehog kit. And you get enough for two hedgehogs in there. That's what we love. Now, back to Kaffe Fassett. I don't want to disturb this at all because I'm loving it. The most popular one is citrus. Ooh, which is this one over here. My citrus department over here. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Under £20, yes, please. $17.95 for your Kaffe Fassett citrus. Now, what I like about this one is that you get quite a few different polka dots going through, but you're also getting the stunning florals in there as well. And you just get a bit of everything, but in such warm colours. Oh, you know what I would be tempted to do? If you could go for two, I would love to have that with the lipstick, because then you've got that clash of the oranges and the yellows with the pinks and the purples that you've got with the lipstick. So this one here is your citrus. This is $17.95. stunning 5-inch charm pack, 42 pieces in there. They're not all 42 different pieces. You can see here, look, you've got a repeat there of that one. But to be honest, with some of these really heavily designed pieces, they look all completely different anyway by the time they're cut up. Beautiful. Lots of multi-buyers. I'm so pleased. Please check out your basket to guarantee that order. Now, Ireland is the next most popular. Hey. Producer Paul's just giving us some quite bad Irish accents because it's an island. No, that wasn't any better. Happily, my accents are even worse, so I'm not even going to attempt anything. Okay, this is your island here. It's a smorgasbord of purples and greens and pinks. I don't have a favourite this hour. It's too difficult to choose. It's just too difficult. But have a look at all these greens and the blues that you've also got by the half metre to pull through, because they are absolutely stunning. Maybe you want to have that hit of pink and purple to merge in through, because you do. Look here. You've got pinks and purples through there that are going to sit really beautifully with that. So the Kaffe says, doesn't he? I mean, to quote the man himself, if in doubt, add 20 more colours. So I think that's fair. You could buy all three. And then just merge it through. Yeah. But then what are you going to back it in? Are you going to go crazy and you know, do your half metres for your backing? We'll look at that in a moment, because I've got one last charm pack for you to look at. And this is your lipstick. Yeah. So we're looking at those, that wonderful clash of pinks and oranges and reds in this, with a splash of purple and then a hit of green coming in. That's what we're looking at with this one. But then you've also got that beautiful cabbage rose coming through there as well. So you've got the natural elements, you've got the stylized one, you've got your absolutely perfect polka dots there, you've got your more organic polka dots there, you've got, you've just got beautiful, beautiful colours. Look at this, you've got, there you go, that bit there coming through. So you get that hint. So you've got almost like an oil painting of floral there, and then more stylized coming in there. It's just gorgeous. And then just a very, very, very delicate print in there. In fact, you can barely see it. You have to come in really, really close. So it almost looks like a plane, but it's not. Of course it's not. It's Kaffe. It's not plain at all. But you've there. So you've got that. And I thought I'd checked, because I thought maybe I'd got it round the wrong way. But no, that is it. It's just a very, very delicate, subtle hint. But you see, that's pulling up those colours in there in just a lighter form. Just beautiful. Now, your magenta gerbera is one that I would absolutely love to see with this. Isn't it gorgeous? So this is your magenta gerbera. This is by far the most popular by the half metre, but there it is. As it is the most popular piece, check it out. Don't miss out. Yours won't necessarily have fluff on it. Well, I can't guarantee that. Might do. Is this still on there? Get off, fluff. There you go. That is your magenta gerbera. Gerbera is... Oh, there's another piece of fluff. It's fluff-tastic this morning. Can we look at another bit that doesn't have any fluff on it? No. There we go. That is your magenta gerbera, £6.95 per half a metre. Real warmth and richness coming through with this. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Do you know what I've just found down here? Over here in the lipstick range, pretty much the same colours. The polka dot. Hey, now, what about if you wanted to quilt with this, if you made a 5-inch, some extra ones to go with your lipstick? There, you could, that would fussy cut up a treat, wouldn't it? So that is your Kaffe Fassett magenta gerbera, £6.95. Yeah, what would we like to look at next? Next most popular is the which one? Yellow paint pot. Oh, sorry, sorry, sorry. Oh, stay there and behave yourself, hedgehog. Thank you. Excellent. There we go. There he is. He was just bowled over by all the colour. Paint pots in yellow. This one here. This is the next most popular. Actually, yeah, this has always been a popular one, the old paint pots. What are you going to do? Message in. Let me know what you're going to do with all of these. I'd love to know, because that's such a big, bold print. Maybe you're going for the citrus, and actually you're going to work through some of these, cut up your own 5-inch squares as well, and have that as because it's not quite as busy as some of the other prints. Yeah, maybe that's the way. I don't know. Message in, let me know, because, you know, I'm nosy. I like to know these things. And also, it's just sharing, isn't it? Now, the raked cobalt. You say, oh, hang on, I've dropped one. I just dropped one, it's fine. Sorry. No, I was not trying to sneakily take it home. It got caught up on my raked cobalt. See, whatever, says Brigitte. He doesn't believe me. They know how much I love a bit of Kaffe. £6.95 for your raked cobalt. £6.95. This works beautifully with your island. Oh, now if we're going for the island theme and thinking, yeah, you know, an island, maybe that's your beach on the back. Life is a beach. There it is. Yeah, doesn't that work beautifully with that? It does, yeah, you see. Whip-woo indeed. Indeed a bit of whip-woo. Beautiful. Next most popular. Squiggle pink, this one. Which I always think should be squiggle mauve. It's not. This is squiggle pink. And I think sits very happily between the lipstick and the island. But then actually you could also get away with it with the citrus as well. No, you can use this wherever you like. But message in and tell me what you're going to do, because I'm just giving you my ideas. But, you know, you are far cleverer than me out there. So let me know what you're doing, because I'd like to know. I'd love to know. £6.95. That is your Kaffe Fassett pink squiggle fabric. VMRW 78. Yeah. That wouldn't that look really pretty in a little girl's dress? I think it would be beautiful. Now, let's stick with the raked for a while and have a look at the pumpkin one. Perfect for October. Perfect for your citrus as well, if you're going for your citrus. This is a real showstopper fabric, isn't it? Oh, what about putting it... Hang on. I'm going to pop this, just controversially. Poor producer Paul, what is she doing now? I'm just going to pop it over here. Sorry, producer Nitro. I'm quite liking it over here with your gerbera and your squiggle mauve and then that. Yes. Do you like that one, producer Paul? Do you like those together? What's the feeling? Yeah. Like it a lot. But also, show it over here. I'm going to go over the paint pots. Yeah. Look at that. Let's cover up the paint pots and let's look at it with the citrus up here. Can we move that up any? Look at that. Yeah. It's just picking out all those colours. Jacqueline in Greater Manchester. Good morning. She says, hi, Tasha. What is the size of the charm pack pieces, please? They are 5 inches. You get 42 of them and they are 5-inch charm packs. All cut, ready to go. So exciting, isn't it, when it comes through the post and you're like, yes, what am I going to do? Vanessa in West Midlands says, great show, Natasha, just ordered my first Kaffe fabric, just want to feel the quality. Vanessa, you are not going to be disappointed. It is absolutely glorious. It's great weight, beautifully printed. I think that's the thing, isn't it? For example, let's take this one here. This is from the lipstick. You could not, whoops, slippery. There we go. No, it's back again. Sorry. You could not print that on a poor quality.
You couldn't. It would bleed, it would be a mess. And also, the actual quality of the print has to be absolutely spot on. And that's what you're getting with this high-quality kaffe. And that's what shines through. It's like cooking, isn't it? If you use quality ingredients, you can't go wrong. It kind of doesn't matter how you put this kaffe together. I mean, when I was laying these out, it was literally as they came off. Dunk, 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 dunk. You can spend hours playing. And Kaffe does. He has a big sort of felt wall, and so he pins it all up onto the wall to see how the colours all play out. You can do that. You can be Kaffe. You can do that kind of thing. Or I quite like the randomness of how they just come out. So the lipstick one here, I think, works beautifully with so many of the half metres, but we'll get to that in a moment. Move out of my way, squiggle. And paint pot, you can go and sit over there. So within this, because maybe you're going to want to sash it in something, maybe you want to sash it in one of the half meters that we've got for you. But then also, you've got in there, so you could go. Now yesterday, I'm just trying to think what the name of it was. We had two different autumnal bundles which would have worked beautifully. There was one which had port and pumpkin and all those kind of colours, and that would work beautifully with this. But then you've also got these pinks in. You've got magentas in there, you've got reds, you've got oranges. It's a real clash of warm colours. But then you've also got in here that little secret hit of citrus green. And you've got that up there as well. So it, just all these colours play out, emerge and mix and play a treat. But if you wanted to mix it in with the island, so you see, this is what I'm doing with one of my Tilda quilts, is that I'm working through the different collections. So maybe what you could do is work in some of the green from the island. And then that starts to change the feel of it again, but it's not out of place because you've got the green there. So you'd pick up the green from that, but that's out of the island one. But there's no reason why you can't mix and match. All three of these collections have got similar colours in. So if you were to just buy all three and just mix and match them all, and I think some of you are doing that, and actually let's just try. Just, producer Paul gets nervous when I say things like, I'm not going to mix up the charm packs. Not so that I can't unmix them. I promise. So let's have a look at the island details. But if I were to get, so just say I was in the lucky, fortunate position where I could get all three charm packs, then maybe this is what I would do. Maybe I would chain piece one from the lipstick. And this is all just randomly generated. And there you go, that one's from the island. And so, look, you've got that green pick up there. And then one from the citrus. And then you might do the same again, but do it the other way, so that you could spin it. So one from there. Maybe this time you'd then pick up a citrus and go there and just mix them through. And then your next one, like that. So I'm mixing these. So this here is a mixture of all three of the charm packs, but doesn't it look great? So you just get that hit of different colours. Now I'm going to put these back before producer Paul gets upset that I've mixed them up and can't remember where they go. Now, a message from Leslie in Shropshire. She said, morning, Tasha. I've made fabric weights with my Kaffe paint pots fabric. Oh, lovely. Got the island charm pack. Lots of love. Oh, brilliant. Yeah, well, that's just it, isn't it? You see, not all of these fabrics, you can't, there comes a time, doesn't there, where you can't have any more cushions, apparently. So I'm told. I don't know. But apparently there is, so my husband keeps trying to tell me. And so you then need to get other ideas to get this fabric in your house used and looking lovely. So Leslie, thank you. That's a great idea. So, you know, she's used the paint pots for fabric weights. Brilliant. Now, I'm going to put, I'm going to put the raked down there, and then we're going to look at the red squiggle, which is over here.
Here we go. Now, where... Ooh. If you wanted to be very controversial about it all, what about that as a backing for the lipstick? I don't know, I'm just saying, because you've got that red in there. What do you think? So that actually when you... even just for the binding, so that you've got... I don't know how I feel about that. I don't know how brave I am with colour, but you've definitely got that red in here, so you've kind of picked that out. But if you had that as the backing, I don't know, I'd just throw that out. Or would you... The safer option, of course, would be the gerbera. Of course it would be. Mmm. Now, if you want some inspiration, rather than just me playing with the fabrics, which I love to do, don't get me wrong, but there's someone that's a bit better at it than I am. And that's Kaffe, you know. So let's have a look. Kaffe's quilts in Italy, this one here. Okay, so Kaffe's Italian journey, shall we say, is a really beautiful one. And he did send someone ahead to kind of try and find somewhere to go and take a look, see what he could find. And this is how the book works. So you get all of the introduction about what it's about, but then you get the quilts. So for each of the quilts, you get beautiful, inspirational photos, all those things there. Look at that. You see, I love that the backing is always as beautiful as the front. And then... Oh, yes. Look at those colours there, that hit of colour. You could use the raked fabric, couldn't you, and the citrus through that. And then for each of the quilts, look at that. You then get all of the instructions. The making instructions are in the back. And that's how it works with each of the books. So you then get step by step how to make each of the quilts. Look, I mean, this is, if you want to make this exactly like that, then that's the fabric that you need to buy and exactly how much. It gives you the codes and everything else. But if you want to do it with your own fabrics, your different fabrics, then you can substitute in. There we go. Now, Morocco is next. The standout one for me with the Morocco is, of course, the shoes, and that's the one that made it onto the front cover. So he said that as they were just walking through, that was it. They found these shoes, and it just fit with one of the quilts. So it wasn't that he'd sent a search party ahead to find things here. This is... it's shot in a location that he always heard people talking about growing up. And then he actually got to go to Morocco and to this certain town. There it is. And then he just found those shoes and it just fitted in with the quilt. It was absolutely perfect. And the colourways, a lot of this was actually shot at the hotel that they stayed in because it just so happened that the colours were there and it was right and it was beautiful. But you've got all of these. And then there's the teapot one. I love the teapot one. But you see, look, you can, when you've got such stunning... detailing, you know, look, there you go. So you can use the ones that we've given you here and just do it in a different colorway. And then again, there are your instructions. Yeah, look at that, beautiful. So why not? Hey, now look down here, just very quickly, look, their edges a little bit like we've just done with Jenni, aren't they, sort of snowballing. Now, brilliant little patchwork. Maybe you love those as a coffee book table, a coffee table book. You know what I mean? But maybe you are just starting out and you want a smaller project, or maybe you want to do several little items that aren't going to take you a huge amount of time. Then what about this? This is your brilliant little patchworks. Maybe you've just finished a massive great big quilt and you want something that's going to be a bit of a change of pace, not going to take you quite so long. Whoa, look at that. So lots of different inspiration through here. Different projects. Look at that for a bolster cushion. Fab. But peace. So maybe you've got your charm pack. You want to do a take on some of these. Then it's all there to do.
Maybe you just want to look at the colourways and go, okay, I've just bought the lipstick, it's that kind of colourway, what am I going to do with that? Could I do something just around using those colours? I've just got the island, maybe I could use that, because actually, you do have those kind of fabrics within the island one. Hey, there you go. There's your flower power kimono. Yeah, beautiful. There you go. And that's the island colours, isn't it? Gorgeous. And then the last one to look at. Sorry, Mr. Hedgehog, you can now go back there. Limited stock on this one. This is your brilliant little patchwork cushions and pillows. Very limited. This was the one that we took the ideas out of when Kaffe actually came on the show. And he brought with him onto the show so that we could all ooh and ah over it, which was really fab. Where is it? Oh, right, it wasn't that one. But actually giving lots of ideas here. Where's it gone? Hey, if you're buying one of these charm packs, there you go, job done. Ta-da! Beautiful. And then maybe you get the half metre fabrics just to do your backing. Just a thought. But he does talk through, actually, in here. It's just a note. He does talk through colour placement for you there. Hey, you could get... If you've got all three different collections, you could do... Because look, so that's like the lipstick one, isn't it? No, actually, is that the citrus one? That looks to me like that's the citrus collection. That is. That's your citrus one. Yeah, and then I still haven't found it. Hang on, bear with me. Just pull them through. There, that's the one. And he brought that actual cushion into the studio. We had that actual cushion in the studio. It was so exciting. And we had Jess Entwistle, who nearly passed out with excitement when she saw it. It was brilliant. And then we made our own version of it, which he was thrilled by. You know, he didn't mind, because I wasn't sure. You know, it's like, there's your beautiful idea. We've just, you know, given you a few ideas as to how to do something similar. And he was really delighted. And he said that he learns from other people's work as well, seeing things like that. Right, what am I looking at next, Bridget Ball? Orange paint pods is here. Here it is. Oh. Yeah. If you want a meter of this, say, for example, then when you are on the internet, you just put 2 in the quantity and that will give you 1 long meter length. Okay, it won't be cut up into 2 lots of half meter, it'll be 1. When you order fabric from us, by the half meter, it comes in 1 continuous length. If you're ordering a bundle, it will be pre-cut. So $6.95, you can have as many half metres of those as you fancy. So maybe you are using this as a backing for your quilt, in which case, perfect. Absolutely perfect. Buy as much of it as you wish. Maybe you want to make an apron out of it, or cushions, or cushion backs, or I don't know. There's a wealth of opportunities. Or maybe, like I think it was Leslie, you want to do fabric weights. Perfect. Yeah, anything you like. Now, the most popular charm pack today is the island. Not surprised. Well, hang on, that's changed, hasn't it? We're having a little move around. Okay, so Producer Paul says, in true Producer Paul style, you are going to have to check out your baskets. If you want to absolutely be sure to get hold of the island one, and look, it goes beautifully with so many of the squiggles and things. This is one I haven't seen before, actually. I like that. Very delicate and pretty. But then you see you've got that cross hatch there. You could always play noughts and crosses with that, couldn't you? So, those of you buying this today, congrats. Oh, my word. Are these who have actually bought? Oh, so those of you who have absolutely, and that's just this one, to name but a few, Mary, Elizabeth, Evelyn, Kay, Val, Linda, Carol, Jeannie, Catherine, Lillian, a name I have no idea how to pronounce. It looks a bit Irish. Yvonne, Stephanie, Jacqueline. Catherine's bought a couple.
Doreen. Somebody else has bought a couple. Carol's bought another couple. Alice, Susan, Christine, Isabel, Vanessa, Anne, Judith. And that's just people who have bought. And then there's a whole load of you now that have got them in your baskets or are talking to customer services. If you want to talk to customer services, it's free to do so. It's a UK call number, 0800 112 4433. Yes, TERW35. If you're after the Island Charm Pack, give us a call. Don't miss out. There it is. Beautiful. Now, the next one to show you is the lipstick one. There you go. So this is your lipstick one here. We're looking at a riot of pinks and reds and oranges and purples, and then a hit of citrus green in there. And these were just a few. You're getting 42 5-inch squares in this. We should really have written 5-inch charm pack, shouldn't we, on our instructions so you could see. So $17.95, HQRW75, 42 5-inch. That's what you're looking at, 5-inch charm packs. Yeah. I would, okay, and this is just me, just my preference, be putting the Gerbera. Yeah, let's look at the Gerbera. I'd be booking the Gerbera as my backing fabric if I was making this out of a quilt, or if I were making it, if I were going to make this into cushions, then I might use this. But also, well, no, I know if you got a lot of it, but I'm just going to show you, for example, over here. So this one here, this is just one of your Gerberas. But also, if you wanted to pad out, if you wanted more, then if you fussy cut like that, your 5-inch square, look, you'd get a whole Gerbera, which would look amazing. So that might be your centerpiece of your quilt, and then you work out from there, and then you have that as the backing. I don't know. It's so much choice. So much choice, but it is a beautiful one. And I would really, really love a little girl's dress out of that. I don't necessarily want to have the little girl that goes with it, but I would really like to do a little girl's dress out of that. Maybe I'll have to do one for my niece. Yeah. Cobalt blue in the raked. Yes. Here we go. Look at, what do you see? What do you see when you see this? Producer Paul sees yarn. Tim's on cameras this hour. Sometimes we call him Director Tim, but right now he's cameraman Tim. Tim, what do you see? Oh, he sees yarn as well. The boys are all going yarn. Whoops. Award-winning director Mike says bananas. I don't believe you. Oh, no, actually, no, we see what you mean about the bananas. But surely that's in the pumpkin that's more banana-y. If you've got a banana that colour, something's gone wrong, surely. Or maybe you're at, like, a Heston Blumenthal restaurant where they do weird stuff. A banana at night. A banana by moonlight. How very romantic. darling, a banana by moonlight. Well, that sounds wrong, doesn't it? Excellent. Right. Let's look at one that might be more banana-y. Bananas by daylight, a.k.a. pumpkin raked. There it is. There are bananas. Very bright, very cheerful, very jolly. $6.95, that's your pumpkin raked. Yeah. Now, this, of course, is going to go stunningly with your citrus charm pack, in my humble opinion, of course. Here we go. This is your citrus over here. And you've got that, again, you've got that beautiful clash of your pinks and your reds and your oranges. This would work really well if you wanted to add this in with your lipstick charm pack. Yes. Yes, yes. In fact, all of them, because you've got all the colours, it doesn't matter. Yes, yes, and more yes. Let me show you that with that. Mm, yes. Look at that. I do like my cave. Producer Paul says you like your cave, don't you? I'm going to be honest. Right, I'm going to be completely honest. When I first saw a Kaffe Fassett charm pack, I just didn't know what to make of it. I was like, whoa, I don't know. There's so much going on. I didn't get it. And then because we had him on the show and because I had to research him so heavily for the interview, because I had 2 hours with him live, I've never met him, I really started to grow in respect for him. He's such an all-round talented artist, not just a painting artist, fabric design artist, quilting artist, knitwear artist, you know, just everything. I mean, this guy, his very first knit thing that he ever knitted, and he got someone to teach him on the train back from the Shetland Islands, because he'd bought some yarn, he thought it was really pretty, and he got someone to teach him how. And by the time that he'd knitted his very first item, he went to Vogue and said, hey, how about using this? They put it on the cover of Vogue magazine, his very first piece of knitwear. I mean, the guy is so inspirational. And what he's really inspired in me is that you can use colour. Don't be afraid of colour. Don't shy away from colour. It's absolutely okay to use. The colours make us happy. That they really... A friend of mine, Martha, she blogs about colour all the time and about how it changes your mood, how it makes you happy. And this is what... I mean, look at it. This desk makes me happy. Look at this colour. It's just stunning. How can you have a bad day when you look at colour like this? And don't be afraid to use it, that there is no right or wrong. And growing up... As someone that drew all the time, I used to work as a scenic artist. I was really afraid of getting things wrong, and actually I wish that I'd had Kaffe there telling me, no, there is no wrong. It's just actually the things that you consider wrong become the character of your work. And if someone had told me that, I probably would have carried on with that, because it would have taken the fear out of it. So the things that you might not necessarily think are right in your work are actually the character of your work. That's what makes yours different to other people's. And when you start to realise that, what I like isn't going to be what you like necessarily. That's why I try and give you as many different options as possible. But it's yours, and it's specifically what speaks to you, what sings to you, and what makes your heart happy. And this desk makes my heart happy. Beautiful. End of lecture. Right, yellow paint box next. So they asked me why I liked Kaffe, and that was why. Yeah, sorry about that. I'll just get down off my soapbox. There we go. Bullet point rather than essay. Sorry, producer Paul. This is your yellow paint pots. $6.95. It's not 2019. Shut up, producer Paul. That's so mean. That's your $6.95. HXRW. They're so mean to me. 93. That's your code to get your yellow paint box. Okay. Anything I like, apart from another tirade about colour. I'm going to go gerberas. Not this. I love this. These gerbera prints. Just fabulous. But then gerberas are brilliant too, aren't they? What a fabulous flower. Again, happy plants, aren't they? One of my friends... You see, I never really remember floral displays from weddings, but my friend Nancy had all gerberas as her wedding flowers, and it just looked amazing. And I'll never forget that. It was just stunning. So these are your gerberas. Maybe it's because I have a happy association with them. I don't know. Just love them. So $6.95. That's your Kaffe Fassett Sunshine Gerbera Fabric. What about a big bag out of that? About a big bag. I don't envy poor Amy, who's got to try and help me clear this up in the very short break in between shows. We'll give it a go. But just look, grab the fabric that sings to you, that makes your heart happy, that you want to work with. That's the whole point, isn't it? Get what you want to work with, because then the minute it arrives on your doorstep, that's it, you're going to want to go. The charm packs are perfect because you're not having to do lots of cutting. They are there, ready to play with, ready to work with, ready to absolutely get going with. Yes, producer Paul. Talking of happy, yes. Oh, we had a competition. Oh, we're about to make someone very happy, aren't we? Which was our text to win. Are we doing that now? Can we do it now? Oh, let's do it now. Let's do it now because it's exciting. So we had last week a text to win competition. First time we've ever done anything like that. To win an Elna 240 EX, I believe it was. That was the machine that you were, and you just had to text so, and that was it. That was all you had to do. It was one entry per person. And the winner is of our Elna sewing machine. First time we've ever, ever, ever done a text to win. Drum roll. Is, are you ready for this? Julie Bedford. Congratulations, Julie Bedford. You are getting a brand new sewing machine courtesy of Sewing Quarter, winging its way to you. You're not having to pay £2.95 P&P. No, 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 we're just going to send it to you. Congratulations, Julie Bedford. That's got to be one of our biggest giveaways ever, hasn't it? Surely, an entire sewing machine. That's amazing. So congratulations, Julie. That's going to be coming to you in the post very soon. If you're watching, fabulous, message in, let us know that you know. If somebody who knows Julie is watching, message and let her know. Otherwise, it's just going to turn up on your doorstep. You're going to be like, what's this? I didn't do that. Something that's also very happy this hour, the hedgehog. Now, we are learning, okay? We are learning. We're learning that you love Joe Carter designs, Joe Carter makes, and so we tried really, really hard to bring stocks that would actually last. So I know that a lot of you watch on catch up, on maybe you watch online, maybe you watch on YouTube and catch up, and I know that sometimes there's a frustration if things have sold out. But here he is. We still have a few of him left. So for me, that's great. That means that actually we're starting to get the quantities right. Now, we had lots of ideas for names yesterday. Harold, Henry, Henrietta, Hector, all sorts. We didn't have Boris. Oh, Horace. We didn't have Boris either. We didn't have Horace. So 1795, Horatio Hedgehog. And you can get two. You can make two out of your bundle. 1795. Full instructions, both written and also with your pictures, all there. And you get the full kit. There he is. You even get the stuffing. And you even get little pom-poms for his nose. Everything in there, your thread, your felt, everything. Utterly gorgeous. So you could do, if you were doing a pair, you could do a little bow tie for the boy. A monocle. Yeah, no, we said a monocle yesterday that he needed a monocle. It wasn't your idea. We already had it yesterday, Producer Paul. Sorry. we had that idea yesterday. And also, actually, somebody said, what about an autumn wedding? You could make a Mr. and Mrs. Hedgehog for the bride and groom, which I thought was lovely. TERW35 is your classic island. This has been most popular charm pack-wise this hour. Please check out your baskets because, are we done? That's it. Oh, 30 seconds left. Oh my goodness. All right, please check out your baskets. Make sure that you don't miss out on this beautiful fabric. Get whichever one you think is absolutely stunning because, hey, look, they all are. So you can't go wrong. Can't go wrong with a spot of Kaffe. Now, coming up after the break is Jenni. She's back. Hooray, she's back in another stunning dress collection. Hey, Jenni, what about a dress out of that? Oh, her little face is lit up and she's clapping. I think that's a yes. Right, we will see you after this short break.
Follow us on Instagram. Search for our Sewing Quarter page and follow us to get our latest posts.
Today I'm going to be showing you how to do the herringbone stitch. This is a stitch that's used for holding two layers of fabric together, and its construction makes it ideal for things like stretch fabrics because the stitches will move with the cloth. It's also a really nice decorative stitch. So I'm going to start with my needle and thread. Now I'm actually using embroidery thread so you can see what I'm doing, and I've also put a knot in the end. So starting from the wrong side of the fabric, we're going to go through to the top. I'm actually going to be working from left to right, but you can also work right to left, whatever's comfortable for you. I'm going to start with a diagonal stitch going up. So that's our first stitch. Now you're going to come back on yourself and to the left of that stitch, but this time we're going to come down You want to try and keep this as even as possible. So you can see that we've created our first cross. Now again, going from the left to the right, going to create our stitch. So you can see we've got a cross there and a cross there. So there we have our herringbone stitch.
On Saturday the 7th of October, we're excited to welcome author Jemima Schley to the show. Jemima will be bringing along her two latest books, which offer inspiration for festival gifts and projects using fat quarters. Jemima will be demonstrating some of the fantastic projects from the books and providing an insight into how she turns her ideas into fabulous creations. She'll also be signing copies of her books for viewers to buy. So don't miss our Jemima specials on Saturday the 7th of October at 9 a.m. and 11 a.m. only on Sewing Quarter, Freeview Channel 78.
To our last live hour today. I'm Natasha McCarty. This hour I'm joined by brand new guest Jenni Smith. Lots of love on the messages for Jenni for her very first hour, which was this morning at 9 o'clock. If you missed that, then you can watch again on YouTube or you can watch again on the website. This hour, and she gave us a little bit of a heads up and a hint, foundation paper piecing to create this. Isn't that stunning? Absolutely stunning. Yeah, great excuse to get those fabulous fabrics out. Spot of Tilda, cabbage rose in there. Beautiful. Let's look at the kit for this, because you get 3.5 metres of fabric. Now, clearly one cushion doesn't make 3.5, it doesn't take up 3.5 metres of fabric, obviously. We wanted you to be able to do a couple, and also the book that it's come out of has 50 ideas for using your fabric. So there's plenty of ideas. So, you know, we'd like to give you more. It's as simple as that. So you're going to get your baby pink, baby blue, and then you're also going to get your Tilda, that stunning Tilda. That's your cabbage rose flower there. And then you've got various polka dots all working beautifully. Now, the next one that I'm going to show you, which is also suitable for this design over here, is the Scandi. Let me just move that to there. So, you get your Scandi hearts, and this is the one that we're going to work with this hour. So that's your red Scandi, but look at it with the apple green. Yeah. And then, if you want to pick out that heart detail, then you've got that in your Scandi heart check. And then all of those as well. So a little bit of a Christmassy palette, maybe, dare I say it, but without being in-your-face Christmas. Now, the other two bundles that we've got aren't suitable for this cushion, but we wanted to bring you just fabulous fabric ranges, because this book brings you 50 different ideas. So that's why we've done something a little bit different. We've brought you two bundles that are perfect for this, and then two bundles that are just brilliant fun. So here we go. Again, 3.5 metres in each of these bundles, but look at the colours that we've picked out. Hello, autumn pheasant. Isn't he a bit good?
But you see, this is kind of a linen effect. So maybe you're making a bag or something out of here. I'll show you some other ideas in that book when we go through it. But you're just going to want to make so many items. I wanted to bring you two different types of bundle. So you've got, you know, your pheasant there. Maybe you want to make a bag. But look at all the different colours there to line it with. It just says autumn all over it. Fabulous. Brilliant. So that's that bundle. And you get your thread. Don't forget that. That's your details there. Now, maybe you want, just a different colourway here, in which case we've got the stars fabric. And again, in that linen type fabric, but then look at all the beautiful colours we've put with it. So a pastely range there in tone. Very pretty, really pretty. Maybe you want to make like a baby quilt out of all those colours and then roll it up and make a bag to store it in out of that. I don't know. And then you've got your thread. Now, the book is stuffed full of ideas. Here's the thing. It's a 50 fat quarter make book. Each of these fabrics we've given you half a metre of. So that's two fat quarters, effectively. So we've given you oodles and oodles. 50 big ideas. That's the cushion on the front that we're working with there. There it is, with your templates and everything else. But on page 93... And we've got a few designers that want to make this, so I don't know who's going to actually get it. Look at that. Why not use, you know, do something that I just think that's great. That's your tree trunk cushion, but there's no reason you couldn't do that with your pheasant around the outside and then take some of the colours on top. So lots of different ideas. We will take a closer look at that. In fact, I'll take that with me, and I'm going to take that with me, and I'm going to go meet our new guest. Ha-ha! Good morning. Welcome back, Jenni.
Thank you.
It's very confusing. We've got so many Jennies now. It's obviously a very popular name. Yeah. It's funny, isn't it? You seem to get those names that just, work. Now, you said to us... I always worry when people say that to me. Like, oh, no. What have I said? What are they going to quote me at? Foundation paper piecing. A year ago, you would have gone and made an extended cup of tea and had an early lunch.
Yes.
Don't do that.
No, don't. Stick with it.
Why? Why are we going to give this a go?
Because I think there are so many endless possibilities, and once you understand the basics of putting it together, then you've cracked it. It's literally, at first it feels a little bit counterintuitive because, first of all, you're sewing through paper on your sewing machine, which is a little bit weird. If you've been used to English paper piecing, you work with paper but by hand. You're sewing on the back, you're flipping your fabrics, and it just feels like a little bit scary. And even when you first start doing it, those first couple of seams, you worry, is it right? And then once you get used to that, it's fine. And it means that you can get really, really exact points, which is brilliant. It's not as time-consuming as English paper piecing, which I love, but I think it's got its place. You know, you've got to have good light, you've got to have enough time to sit and do that. So I just think foundation paper piecing is another string to your bow, really, if you're a quilter. And I think when you, especially now when I'm looking at books or when I was at Quilt Market and Festival of Quilts, there are so many amazing patterns out there, and it's, there's only going to be coming more and more because it's such a trend at the moment that you don't kind of want to feel left out. I think if you feel like you can understand it, then it'll be really, really rewarding.
So why did you give it a go? Because you dress make, you quilt, you design your own patterns. Why just go, hang on, something else?
Well, partly, I think the pattern that I first did was one that had a spiral of flying geese round that requires very small pieces of fabric. So actually, like on this quilt earlier, when you had those small triangles left, pieces like that can be used in foundation paper piecing. So that's one good reason.
It's less a really waste.
Good, yeah, it's a really good scrap buster. And if you've loved working with a fabric, you know, it's really nice if you can make a cushion or something to complement a quilt. And I think as well, it's got quite a wow factor. I think maybe, it's quite nice to make, when people look at a foundation pieced cushion or a quilt, they're really impressed. You know, technically, I think it looks really, really impressive. So I just didn't want to miss out, really. I wanted to know how to do it.
You can kind of hear people's brains singing, and how did you do that? How does that work? How did you put that together? And this is the effect. This is the one that we've gone for today.
but in a different colourway. What's the first thing that we need to do?
OK, the first thing that you need to do in this book is to actually photocopy the templates, because you physically use the paper when you're sewing. So you need to have, you can't trace them off, you just need to photocopy them onto copy paper. And in this case, you also need to enlarge it up to 200%.
And there it is. So you just photocopy that page up to 200%.
Yes.
Either, if you don't have the means to do that, take it to your local newsagent.
Yeah, exactly.
They'll do that for you.
Yeah.
Or just find yourself a teenager. They generally know what they're doing.
Yes.
Because a lot, I mean, my printer at home will photocopy and I can scale up, scale down. Now, there is one thing. This isn't our fault. It's just a glitch in the book. There is one thing, and it happens.
Yes.
Is that actually one of these, there's a print error. One of these is back to front.
Yes.
So all I would say is that when you print this off, print off two of these.
Yes.
And flip it.
Yes.
One.
Yes. You can see from these shapes here, the B and the D, that they are a pair and they're going to stitch together afterwards. A and the C are actually printed with the same orientation. And again, you need those to be mirroring each other. So it's just a case of tracing through that line to the other side and, okay, and then transferring the number. So it's a 2-minute job. And thankfully, we've spotted it and we can help you so you don't get
stuck.
Well,
that's the thing, isn't it? You know, we're only people that they're own human that put these books together.
Yeah.
Mistakes happen. But actually, great that you found out. I mean, I think you thought that it was some kind of test.
Yes.
Like some sort of fabric Mensa test. To see if, does she really know what she's doing? It wasn't. It was just that accidentally the one we picked had an error on it.
Yes.
But now we know exactly what to say. Flip it, draw around it,
yes,
and use the number order that is on A. And that's all you need to do.
On C.
So 1, 2, 3, rather than 1, 2, 3.
OK.
So when you've done that, you're good to go.
Yes.
So like you say, 2-second job.
Yes. And I think it's really good that we're doing this on here, because I think people can watch this programme back afterwards, can't they, on YouTube? And with foundation paper piecing, I think it's a visual skill to learn.
I would need hand-holding, not
yes,
going to lie.
But yeah. I think if you read a book, I'm not sure that I would have managed to actually do it myself first time, but being shown by somebody how to do it and then being able to watch that back is going to be really helpful to people, I think. So it's the perfect opportunity to give it a try.
Yay! And a gorgeous result, let's face it. Absolutely
yes,
stunning result.
And it's this actually is called the Hothouse Pillow Set, because it encourages you, and with the fabric allowances that you've given, is to make two.
Yes.
And again, I think that's brilliant, because I think whenever you're learning a new skill, if you do it twice, then you've usually cracked
you've got it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So.
And the nice thing about this is, because you're getting so much fabric, you don't have to do exactly the same colourway, so you can have same but different.
Yeah.
But look at that. I mean, just beautiful. Really beautiful. Okay, so we've photocopied.
Yes.
We've cut out, not with our fabric scissors, with craft scissors.
Yes.
Actually, we've got an old pair of scissors that we've just written paper scissors on.
Yeah, I've got some old scissors here. And, I mean, some people do even use 2 rotary cutters when they're dealing with foundation paper piecing, if you're doing a lot of it or a big quilt, because you do cut through the papers. So that's your choice, really.
Yeah,
if
I
not,
have
you
a
may need to change
paper
your
rotary cutter.
Yes. Oh. So you're an expert at this. You can help me.
No, I didn't say that I'd done it on this. I just said I have a paper rotary cutter.
Just in case.
Foundation piecing, just like to make that really clear. I'm in the camp of...
fear.
Yes. I was going to say cup of tea, but yeah, no, let's go fear.
Okay,
but you're going to make this right for
yes,
me. Okay, good.
Okay, so the first thing is don't cut on this line here as yet, because that's actually your stitch line for later. So you just want to give yourself an inch or so perimeter around the template when
okay,
you start.
So this is looking up already. I don't have to be accurate with my cutting.
No.
Excellent. Good.
Not at the moment. They come later. But I think the temptation, usually, you get a book, you get a pattern, and it's, you know, your natural thought is to cut on the line. So just remember that you need to just leave a little bit around the edges. And then what you need to do, and the books, you know, guide you through this, is decide on your colour scheme and which fabrics are going to go on which piece of the pattern. And what I always do, if you're doing a big quilt, you would set out a kind of key that you've got as a reference all the time. But you need to write your colours on there or your fabric. So you can see on here, I've put red spot, hearts, flower, which is the big, lovely signature print, really, the Scandi print, and then green hatch. I wouldn't skip that step because it's easy to get muddled up once you get started, so that will just always be helpful.
It only takes for the daughtering, because the postman staggering under all your sewing quarter goodies that are arriving, for your attention to be taken away and not to remember quite where you were when you left off.
Yeah.
Or for the cat to, which is generally what happens in my house, to jump up and send everything flying, and then, and yeah, it jumped up on Lucy's quilt the other day,
so
she's got a little in her quilting.
It's a memory. Every quilt should have a mistake.
Yeah, absolutely. Or several if they're mine. Right, where do we start?
So the book tells you then the rough shapes to cut that are going to then equate to these shapes on here. So that's really helpful when you're starting out with this technique as well, that you've got a guide. As you get more experienced, you'll look at this and you'll eyeball it, and you may be able to be a little bit more economical with your fabric. But the best tip I got when I started this was just be kind to yourself. Like, first time around, you haven't done this before, so cut your pieces a bit bigger, because you end up putting shapes on different angles, and even if you think you've got plenty, it can be a little bit short. So don't try and be too economical. It feels strange, but I think it will help you get better results and not get stressed about it. So the first thing that we do is, these templates are always numbered in the order that you've got to put the fabric onto them. So the first one we know is number one, B1 in this case, which is the heart fabric.
Okay.
And that's what I'd already cut, as they told me, to the dimensions here. So the first thing that you do is you get, if you've got one of these...
And these are the add a quarter rulers. And anybody that does foundation paper piecing has always raved about these.
Yes.
Because I'm not a foundation paper piecing, I have to take your word for it. But it's got a lip. If I can just show at the side there. We've got two. We've got a 6-inch and a 12-inch. This is the 6-inch smaller one. You can get them in a bundle for both. But you see that lip there? That is your quarter inch. So when it says add a quarter, well, you're going to show us how it works.
Yeah, and actually then the finer side of it, here, is... So this little bit here is for when you're folding the papers.
Useful.
So otherwise you can use just a little bit of cardboard, but that's why that's there. You shouldn't ever use that side for cutting, because if you look at mine... You can see.
Oh, look. Yeah. So Someone was naughty.
That was a mistake. So that's a good tip. So only use the lip side for when you're cutting later on. But I'll show you how to use it. It's not a gadget that's not useful. It's brilliant. It makes life loads easier.
So, show us.
Right. So the very fine side is to crease this line here. So you put it on like that, and then you fold.
Oh, so you've got your fabric underneath already?
Well, I've got that in place, but initially, the first thing to do with this template is to fold the line. And the first line that you're going to stitch is between number one and number two. So that's your first, and you can score the paper very easily then. And then what you do is... you turn it over and you put your first piece of fabric on the back here. So you're actually stitching on this side, but this side is how it's going to look when it's finished. And this is the point where you're thinking, oh, I'm never going to understand it. And you'll probably do this wrong once or twice. I did. But then once you've unpicked it and you understand, the trickiest bit is getting started. And once you've got that... on your first couple of blocks, then you're away, OK?
It's like anything, though, isn't it? The start of it is always the trickiest.
Yes. So that's going to be folded like that. And then the next fabric...
Why is that not coming off?
Oh, sorry. Yes. So what I've just done, and what quite a lot of people recommend, is just with this first one, to get it in position, is just to pop a little dot of glue.
Oh, your English paper piecing glue?
Yes, and just stick it on, and then you know that that's not going to shift.
Ah, great.
Because you're actually stitching on the other side. And once you've got started further on down the line, you don't need to glue. It's just for that,
just initial
first piece.
£5.95 for your glue stick. It comes with a refill, and then you can buy refills also from us. OK, so it's glued on.
So it's glued on, and then what you're going to do is fold it back on the line mm-hmm. that you've already made clear with the ruler, and then this is where you can actually already at this stage get rid of the excess fabric that
Oh, really?
You're not going to use. Yeah. So the add a quarter ruler just sits on the edge of the paper like that, and then you can cut that away. And that's done.
Excellent.
Okay, so the next part, B2, is red spot. And what you do is, sometimes at this stage you have to look into the light. So what I'm doing is I'm placing the red spot here. And I know that when this is stitched and folded backwards, that it's going to cover up behind there. So sometimes you need to just be able to...
So you need a light box or a window, basically.
Yeah, it's quite handy to be next to a window when you're doing this.
We say in a studio with a lot of lights, but they're all facing us, and no windows. So, yeah, but at home, obviously, you've got a window.
So that is going to be there like that. And for these first... But you're not stitching on this side. So, again... This is the only time I usually use a pin. You can just pop a pin through there so that you know that fabric's not going to shift.
Right.
Okay?
Okay.
Has everybody gone for a cup of tea?
No, they're there. They're there. Oh, I'm assuming they're there. We're all intrigued.
Okay, so then what you're going to do is go over to the machine. And again, I really like to use the satin stitch foot.
Right.
That I mentioned earlier, the F foot, because it's really open. And I can see exactly where the needle's going.
Now, you call this the F foot. Is that the same on every machine? Do they...
It always seems to be an F foot, that, yeah. It's the one for when you're doing your zigzags and your decorative stitching, because it's wide, so when the needle's shifting from left or right to do a decorative stitch, there's plenty of space for it, basically.
And it's got that metal... I like to call metal skids. To lift it over so that when you've got that raised... cotton from your satin stitches, it'll just go over the top of it.
Yes.
But here, perfect, because you can really see what you're doing.
Yes. And what you're going to do, what's the key really here is stitch length.
Okay.
So when you're foundation paper piecing, at the moment you're stitching through the paper and you're stitching both pieces of fabric together.
Okay.
So you need a small stitch.
Okay.
Because at the end, all those papers are removed.
See, it's like you're perforating it, like a perforated edge.
Yes. So you're getting a lovely, lovely clear line, which is why you can get such neat points, because you're literally just stitching on the line. You're not worrying about seams. So when you make a point with two lines meeting, it's bang
it
on there.
Is.
Yes. But and then you take the papers out afterwards. So if you use a regular stitch length, so when you switch your machine on normally, the default stitch length is 2.2. That means you're getting about 10 stitches in an inch. You want to go down to between 1.5
oh, wow. So
and 1.8.
Okay.
So okay. The pain is if you have to unpick it, it's tiny.
Okay.
But they're normally quite short distances. And the benefit is that when you're taking the papers out later, then it's not going to start to fall.
Because I have already had producer Paul in my ear going, Tash. Is she about to stitch your paper? Is that right? Yeah, that's right.
Eventually it would probably blunt your machine needle, so that's just something to look out for. If you're switching between foundation piecing projects and others, you know, keep an eye on that.
Okay.
Now then, so I've
put
mine, I found my pedal, and it's quite new to me sewing standing up. I quite like it.
Well, you know, it's another of these challenges we like to set our guests. It's like, hey, you know, come on, we'll give you a pattern that isn't quite correct, and then make you sit standing up. Yeah, and then try and find your pedal as it disappears under the desk. It's all good. That's the joy of live television, ladies and gents.
Thank you. You're stitching with the pattern upright, and what you want to do is start your stitching about quarter of an inch before where the line starts. So I'm just going to put my needle in there. All I'm stitching is this line, but I tend to just start a little bit before and finish about quarter of an inch afterwards. So put the foot down. Stitch length is 1.5, and away we go. So it's quite nice because this is the only line you have to follow. You're just sewing on the printed paper line.
So why
line.
Do you go a bit before and a bit after?
Just because when we fold over and add the next piece on, you'll see I pull the paper back a little bit and fold it, but it just means you're not breaking into that seam allowance. Okay. So it just gives you that little bit of leeway, really. So you don't have to reverse. You just finish off and then come out and put those away like that. So that pin has just been there to keep that in place, and obviously I had a little bit of the glue. So then the next step is to press, please.
Oh, yes. Yeah, sorry, I was so busy engrossed. Hang on. We've got Mary in East Riding who says, really enjoying today's shows. Thank you,
Mary.
Who else have we got there?
You can't get away with finger pressing with foundation paper piecing. There are some little hand rollers that I know are all the craze at the moment in America. They might be appearing here soon. So you could have a little hand roller for, because you're back and forwards quite a bit with this process between the machine and the iron.
Do a tiny little iron. A tiny little super, super powered steam iron.
Okay.
I don't know if we've got that in stock. Beverly in Ayrshire says, I'm here. Welcome, Jenni.
Ah, oh, hello. Right.
Shall I?
Yes.
Do you want me to?
So, literally, you're just pressing what you've just stitched.
And that's okay on the paper?
Yes, that's
and
fine.
And that fabric always goes a little bit darker when you press it, and then it comes back up again.
Yes. So, that is the first two pieces joined, like so. And then what we need to do is fold the next line. So we've gone from between B1 to B2, and now we're going to fold onto this line here because the next line that we're doing is between B2 and B3. And that's why the templates are numbered for you and help you so that you know that. So you can lift the paper. That's where I did the extra little bit of stitching there. So you just lift the paper back a little bit like that. So that's why you just got a bit of extra.
Oh, OK, so a bit of extra security. Yes. So your stitches aren't going to unravel.
And then you're going to go in again with this side of the ruler so that you can fold that back and score that there.
So that's your add a quarter ruler.
Yeah.
It is handy, isn't it? How would you do that otherwise?
You just have to get a piece of card on hand that you can. You need something with a very, very flat
and kind
shallow
of
edge, basically.
Beveled, actually, isn't it?
Yeah.
It helps you do it.
Yes, definitely. So you're folding back, so it's fold and then cut. So we can get rid of this excess fabric
so
here
you're
again.
Tidy as you go.
Yes. Some people, as you get more experienced at it, you would probably have judged the shapes that you need a little bit more, so you may have less fabric, but it's still a good discipline to tidy as you go, because otherwise all of this fabric ends up underneath, and then when you come to quilt something, it just means it's a bit bulkier.
I'm smiling because on Sunday my husband cooked dinner, and he certainly does not tidy as he goes, as a photo on my Facebook page proved.
Oh, really?
Yeah, and it was divided between those who were like, yep, my husband's exactly the same, and those who were like, well, just be grateful that he cooked. And I was like, yeah, no, it is love-hate. Love that he cooks, hates the mess he makes.
So that's gone away to there.
Right.
OK, so next up we know that it's the flower that needs to be added on.
Mm-hmm.
So what we're going to do is we're back onto this side. We're putting the right side down onto the line that we've just cleared there. And then again, it's just checking the angle. So in the light, it's checking that that, once it's stitched and folds back on itself, is going to be sufficient to cover all of that. And that's why it's great to go a little bit bigger, because the angles can be a little bit deceiving when you're not used to doing this.
Yeah, they really can, can't they?
Yeah.
So with this, if you wanted, when it was the other way, when it's there, if you wanted to just pop a pin in to hold it so you could flip it over and check, can you do that?
Yes, and I mean, you can definitely do that. Okay. You can't glue at this stage because obviously you would be gluing it to fabric. So you can only do that the first time because you can physically glue it to the paper. But from then on, in fact, and because this is quite a big piece, often with foundation paper piecing, you work in much smaller scale. This is big and could flap about in the mechanism of turning it over. So it is probably a really good idea just to pin that anyway. So we'll pop one in there. It's going to be way... I know I'm stitching here, so if you pop a pin out of the way...
Can then keep it in?
Then you can keep it in, because it's not going to... It's not going to affect. So the next line that I'm stitching is this line here.
Right. Okay.
So...
I just want to see this, and then we'll go and show... all of this fabric. Intrigued. You can tell everyone's intrigued. The studio's really quiet. So everyone's like, oh, this is amazing.
Okay. So, there. So I'm starting a little bit before again. And then.
Oh, I should probably have trimmed that as it.
Well, I'm just. I should have trimmed. Let's pop that there. Doesn't matter. That's it. So it's a small stitch length, so you know your lines are going to take a little bit of time.
This is actually something that kids could do, isn't it? If you get your head around the placing of the fabric, because it's just stitching a straight line.
Yeah, yeah. And actually a lot of the patterns that are out there... are really appealing to kids. My friend's just made the gorgeous, a big giraffe quilt. So all the all the face and all the details on the giraffe are all foundation pieced.
That's a labour of love, isn't it? That's incredible. Kaz says, great demo, Jenny. I'm doing EPP at the moment, English paper piecing, for anyone that doesn't know. So I'm nodding agreement with all your tips and advice. Need that ruler, says Kaz, in not so sunny Wales. Oh,
brilliant.
Yeah.
And even at this stage, it's still quite hard to picture the finished item, because essentially four templates. So you've kind of got to keep the faith, because you need four pieces made like that to make one quarter of the cushion. So just believe that the instructions are okay and keep the faith.
Which bit is that? What have we done?
Right, let's look. So this one, this becomes B. Let me see now. Until it's cut, it's quite hard to tell. This is the signature fabric,
that's bit there.
And then, that's going to be the points of the star are the final piece that we're going to add onto this
that
one
here.
So
that will go into there?
Yeah.
Like that?
Yeah, these are the separate pieces that we're going to do, and that's how it all comes together.
Not immediately obvious.
No.
Keep the faith, keep going.
Yes.
Whilst you start to piece the next piece...
Okay.
How many times can I say pieces? I'm going to take the book, I'm going to go show you the fabric over there, and I'm just going to pop that iron under there. Now, Tilda Cabbage is first. That's the one that Jenny made that stunning cushion out of. But by the time that you've done four of those blocks to make your kind of star, and then by the time that you've then repeated it again to get your matching cushion, you're going to be a whiz at this. 33.45, you are getting a whopping 3.5 metres of fabric and thread. So... you've got three different spots, and then you've got your stunning
This is from the Tilda Harvest range, by the way. And as we had that yesterday, that was on a miss it, miss out. We won't be getting that Tilda Harvest back. So if you see it in something like this and you love it, grab it, because we are not reordering that Tilda Harvest. 3345 YZGC99. Yeah, what a beautiful bundle that is. Now, the book that this comes out of is your Fat Quarters, Small Fabrics, More Than 50 Big Ideas. And the thing with the book is that it has so many different ideas that we thought, you know what, let's give you different fabric bundle options, because you've got babies and kids, you've got all sorts of different ideas for them. You've got gifts, you've got all sorts. So it was a matter of actually, the more variety of fabrics we can bring you to suit this book. You see that bag out of the fabrics that we've got, lovely. So we are limited in stock now with this book. Lots of you going for it. I mean, that's a lovely one out of that pheasant fabric that I'll show you in just a moment. So lots of different ideas within, well, 50, in fact. That's the book, that's the one that we've done. Loads and loads and loads of ideas and different scales, different sizes. If you wanted to use your pheasant fabric to do something like that and upcycle something, then you can. There's loads of different ideas, just so much. Gifts, all sorts. It's fat quarters. We've given you half metres, which means that each of these is two fat quarters. So you've effectively got seven fat quarters in this bundle. No, hang on, 3.5 metres. That's more, isn't it? So 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. There you go, 12 fat quarters in here. Okay, this is your pheasant. Very pheasant. But then look at all the colours. So we've found, he's got his sort of maroony face bit. You can see I'm not a pheasant expert, can't you? And so we've picked out the maroon that goes with that. And then we've given you all the different colours that just work. So you can have a brilliant play with that. Now, maybe what I suggested earlier, do what you like with it, but I thought if you were making something for a child, maybe you were doing a beautiful quilt or something and you wanted to gift it, then you could make a bag to put it in. I know that the wedding quilt that my mum had made for us when Stephen and I got married came in an antique pillowcase, which was really beautiful. So I think sometimes if you're giving a quilt, it's lovely to put a little bag or something. So maybe you could do that, because those colours all work and you get your thread. Now, this is the Scandi. This is the one we're working with this hour. So we've seen it made up in the Tilda, gorgeous. We're starting to get an idea of how this is working in the Scandi. We've matched that red with that green. It's a hint towards Christmas colours. There we go. So that's what we've got for you today. This is how it's all looking. Now, yes. Jenny.
So what I've just done is I've added the last one on there. And then what you can see is I've done 1, 2, 3, and 4. So now this is the time when you actually start to cut it down.
Okay.
So that then they become, this is the counterpart to go with that, but then they become cut down. You don't actually cut the second line. At this stage, you cut into the first line because then the darker line inside it is how you then stitch them together.
Okay, right.
So this is the point when, if you did have a different rotary cutter, I've just got this one ready, you would use one for cutting through, because you're cutting through the layers of fabric and the paper at the same time. So you want to line up your ruler. What actually, on this template, if you can see, there are these angles here, but you don't have to worry about those.
Are they just your dog ears that they've sort of removed beforehand?
I think it's just a very precise... It gets rid of a little bit of bulk, because when you're stitching on this line, but to get in with a rotary cutter and do those angles for what's left behind, I wouldn't worry about that too much. So you're cutting on this line.
So either get a different rotary cutter blade, maybe use one that is on its way out, or just know
or
that
you
you're
could
have
use
to
some
replace.
Scissors as well. You don't have to be rotary cutting. So the paper scissors that you used initially, it's fine to use that as well. So you go round and trim that so that you'll end up with one of a template like this, which is ready. And you still then don't actually have to remove the papers at this point because it has the stitch line for the next part when you're going to put it together.
Gosh, right.
Whilst I'm cutting this down, ready to do that, I just wanted to also just give a little chat about the fusible fleece that comes with this kit.
Yes, yes, yes. So it comes, you can buy this separately. Now, why is this? Was this the one?
Oh, this one.
I've got something different.
You have, you've got some.
Ooh.
It's this one here. It's the.
It's so the that's not all we've got. Yeah, this is
640. I mean, both. I've used the buzzle as well. That would be fine.
If you have, we haven't got this one actually on the show. It's that one that we've got scheduled. Okay. So we've given you the wrong one. It's another test, just to see how well you are.
I've used them both. I use a lot of buzzle, fusible buzzle, so that's good too.
So this one, use a damp cloth when you're fusing.
Yes.
Okay. Yes. What about but this one that we've got on the show? Talk us through this, because we haven't had this very often on the show at all. So actually, tell us what this is and why it's great to use.
Is it a stitch-in one or the is it the fusible?
It's the stitch-in one.
Ah, OK. So sometimes you can get this and the top layer or both layers are fusible as well, so people use it a lot in bag making and baskets because it gives a really nice structure as well. If it's sewing... Really, because it's already got... It's hairy if you stroke it.
You know it is, yeah.
It is. It naturally clings to your fabric anyway, in which case I wouldn't worry too much unless you're doing a ginormous bag about basting it in place. You could do some hand basting. You could spray baste it like a quilt, but I think you would find on a project like this, once you've pieced the cushion top and laid it on, it would hold enough for you to then go through and quilt it.
OK. And so... This is just a real stable way of quilting, isn't it? Yeah, you can hear I've got really dry hands at the moment because I've been painting at home and it just takes all the moisture out of the hands. You can hear my rough hands on it. It does, it's kind of trying to.
Yeah,
to
and
stick.
I think if you could just piece a top, a foundation pieced top like that and make a cushion up without quilting it. Mm. But I think putting something behind it and then quilting it gives it that depth. Mm. Because then the stitches sink into the layers a little bit and it looks more structured. And also
it's even more defined, isn't it?
Yes.
Yeah.
And I think when you've gone to all the effort of piecing a top like that, you actually, you want it to stay firm and to be able to see it. You don't want it kind of sagging in at the edges either, really. So it looks nicer because it gives it some structure.
It's going to give you a nice plump cushion,
yes.
Isn't it?
Yeah.
No matter what you're kind of cushioning it with, it's going to make it really
yeah.
raw.
And you don't need to have a layer of something underneath it. If I use scraps of general quilt wadding or batting to put behind a cushion and quilt, because it's quite loosely, that you know, that it can come loose a little bit, I would normally then just put a cheap cotton or something on the back or some polycotton whilst I quilt it. But this is fine just to have the top and onto this and to quilt.
OK, so if I have to wash this, is it going to be OK to wash without having that third layer?
I think so, yeah. It's only on the inside of your cushion.
Yeah. It's all right, the only reason I ask is because I'm in the middle of making a quilted top for my dog bed. And
okay.
I didn't, and so I was like, what fabric? I don't want to waste fabric on the underneath. But actually, this would be perfect.
Yeah, it's fine. The only reason I do it is if I feel I've got a really looser wadding, I put a cotton on the back just so that also when I'm actually physically quilting it, it's not fluffing up all the bottom of the machine.
I need this. $10.95.
See you later.
That's fab. Okay, right, so we've got that. So we're trimming up, making everything nice and neat, ready to go.
Yes.
So that was the one. Can I just hold that up? That was the one that we did earlier. Starting to take shape.
So then, now I've got to. I might need the book for the reference
of
how this all.
Let's find it. There we go.
Look. So we've got that like that, and we're stitching it into that like so.
So it's giving you those stitch lines?
Yes.
OK.
That's right. And what's sometimes useful as well is on here. So you're keeping the papers in, but you can actually pop the pin through on that point there, and you can match it up.
So this is another reason that you get that absolutely crisp point.
Yes, like that, so that you know they're going to match up to sew.
Brilliant.
So when they're... That's essentially this one corner block, so we're getting there, is...
Look at that. But look at that. Perfect. But that's what you're getting. You're getting that perfect, perfect point. Look how all of those meet and are absolutely brilliant.
So that is then, once you've put two units together, like I've just demonstrated, and the mirrored images that you've made, you've got one quarter of the cushion.
Wow. Hey, doesn't that look different in that print? So different in the green and the red. Oh, I like.
Linda says, she's in the West Midlands, she said, love foundation paper piecing, FPP. Great demo, really clear, says Linda.
Oh, thank you. People, what I would just show on here is, if you want to, when you've stitched this together, you can actually keep the papers in at this point. I think people feel like they've got to get onto the next step and be taking the papers out.
It's quite satisfying. Let's be honest, it's like taking, when you get something with a screen and you get to take that plastic off, it's kind of the same. It's like, yeah, quite satisfying to do.
But if you keep them on until a little bit later in the process, what you've got here is a guide for when you're then piecing the four squares together. You've still got your stitch lines there. All that I would recommend doing, and which I did on here, which you can hopefully see, when I stitched these two pieces together, I took away the paper from underneath, just on the seam allowance, before I stitched them together, because that's been stitched through there. And if you don't remove the papers, that's the point at the end when you've got to go in with your tweezers and pick them out.
Is this evening, a bit more tired, sat in front of the telly, just cathartically plucking out your paper?
Yeah, and you've done the stressful bit at that point, you know, so in a way it's a little bit like finishing off the binding on a quilt by hand. It's like... You know, it's quite a long process and you need to do it quite particularly, but you're nearly there. And so you're enjoying the fruits of your labour whilst you're doing it. So, yeah, it's definitely quite relaxing. And I would just say to people, you know, I'll demonstrate, even though I wouldn't remove them at this stage. It's not the end of the world if you do remove them at this stage, because it will hold its structure and you would just then sew it together with a quarter inch seam. Mm-hmm. So you're not losing anything, really. It's just that generally you would keep them in. So you can see, because we've used that small stitch length, that just peels.
It is like a perforation, isn't it? That's all it's done.
But nothing is happening to the thread whilst I'm doing that. If you've got smaller pieces like this that are stitched around all edges, sometimes it's harder to get in. What I just find quite useful, if you just have a pin handy, you can just go in with the pin, not going right through to the front, and start to lift it a little bit like that, so that it'll tear a little bit, and then you've got... You can get in. And then you can start to peel that to the edges like that.
Oh, that is satisfying.
And yeah, if you end up with any, particularly once you've cracked this, and you're all going to be really good at it now. So you're on to your next challenge. And if you're using smaller pieces, then, you know, physically sometimes you just need a pair of tweezers just to be able to get in, because
you know,
it's so small.
Producer Paul, our magnifying tweezers.
Oh, yeah. They sound good.
No, they're great. So it's a tweezer with a four times magnification little magnifying glass, so you can really see. So even if you are working in the evening, you can actually see and really get in.
Okay, wonderful.
I think they're under a fiver, or they're $5.95. They're really inexpensive, but for something like this, perfect.
Yeah. So, and then when you've put it together, I put the fusible fleece or the bozal or something behind it, and then I used a quilting thread to quilt it. So again, I used the Aurifil for that. Now, in terms of doing the actual stitching, You can use a... When you're actually doing foundation paper piecing, lots of people also use 100% cotton threads.
Okay.
Some people would worry that there was snap. I've done a big quilt and there was no snapping at all. So again, it's a very, very fine thread, so it sits nice and flat, which is what you want in this process as well. Otherwise, you can use, you know, your Gutermann and your with a polyester blend. Either or, it's the stitch length that's the key. It's okay. Put in between 1.5 and 1.8 on the stitch length for all the stitching at this stage. And then for the quilting, you know, this, what's going beneath it is quite lofty, so I went up to a stitch length of about 3.5 to then quilt this. And this pattern's quite nice. You could do lots of different things. I could have probably carried on, really. You could have echoed more shapes working round with the quilting. It would even look nice with some hand quilting on there if you wanted to. If your point's not perfect, you could pop a nice button in the middle of the cushion. That's always the default on this one. And then I just, I think the book actually has a zip on the back, but I felt like I'd done quite enough work on the front, and that's how people are going to be looking at it. So I just made an envelope.
I like an envelope back.
Yeah, I do. And actually, it gives you an option. Again, I did just a really nice, it's quite hard to see on here, but I just did a nice decorative stitch on
which
the back
kind of
as well.
Echoes the front.
Yes.
I see that.
I looked
nice
at all
attention
my
to detail.
600 stitches and found one that kind of echoed. It's a lovely kind of half circle.
We're coming in.
Are you coming in? I should have done it in more of a contrasting thread. It's hard with the dot to see.
No, you can see it.
But that's why I love the machines that have got a few more experimental stitches. And another thing is great if you have any variegated threads you do these decorative stitches in them,
beautiful.
It looks like you've been working away at it for hours and yet it's really quick.
So I have something to show you.
Oh. Wowzers. I'll have to pinch these for Kay, who I work with. She was doing a giraffe quilt, like, sat for hours.
But you see, you pull those out. So
yep.
Wherever you need it to be at...
Yeah.
You've got them. Would that work?
That would definitely work, yeah. That would be... I can see how, if you're trying to get in... Oh, yeah. Wow.
Yeah, yeah, no, they'd work. Ooh, yeah, no, they'd really work.
I have got glasses for fine sewing that I sometimes use as well, but yeah, that's brilliant. That would definitely
do the trick.
Be a good kit. Yeah.
Yes.
Wonderful.
Yay!
So they add a quarter ruler, and that.
That's the one. You're set. You're absolutely set.
And a bit of bravery, and you're set.
Oh, brilliant. So we've got your tweezers. We've got your add a quarter. Should we give the details for all of those? So that, for the add a quarter. Because we didn't really touch on that, but I feel that it's quite a vital part of this, because otherwise it's tricky. £10.95 for your add a quarter. That's for your 6-inch one. That's for this one. Now, we've also got the 12-inch as well. You can buy them. You can buy the two together, actually. Let me get you. Excuse me for stretching. This is your 12-inch. So if you're doing these larger designs, great to have. And again, you've got that lip there. That's your adding your quarter. And then the fine end there to fold your paper back on. £15.95. Yeah, there we go. And you're all set. And then grab your book and you're good to go. And this is what you can be making. There we go. Oh, we're sewing.
I just thought I'd just go across this line here to join these two pieces.
So even when you sew down that connecting line, you sew a little bit before and a little bit after?
Yes, I just do that routinely on everything. And then you can, if you just need to fold it back a little bit, you've just got a little bit more room for manoeuvre there. You can obviously pin if you need to at this stage. Or sometimes clips are helpful as well.
Because
wonder clips can work as well. When you're going through the paper. So it's the one quilting discipline when actually you use the quarter inch on the ruler, but you're not using the quarter inch foot.
Yeah.
Otherwise, that will fold back to there.
Oh, are we pressing?
I can press that. Oh, so now if you can see there, oh, I'll show you here. So there's a tiny little bit there, which actually, when I've put that red part back, hasn't quite covered that, but that actually, when I was looking through the lights here, that's not beyond the line.
Ah, so you're still going to catch
once
it.
So once it's stitched into the next part, that is actually going to be caught. And
hang on, let's just raise it so we can actually see where that
you
is.
You just see that this there. So there's just a tiny, it's less than quarter of an inch.
That tiny little piece of, but like you say, when you actually look at it through the light, it's not encroaching into that bit there.
Yeah, but that's a little error on my part, but that's...
But this is how we learn, and yes. Actually because you did that, it's taught us how to check whether or not you have to go back and unstitch,
yeah.
Or whether it's okay to. So I think that's always really handy. Sounds weird, but I quite like it when things go a little awry because
yeah.
They do for me.
Yeah.
And then I know if well, that's
yeah,
okay.
Exactly. And if you went drastically wrong and you'd really missed your angle so that you just know before you add on the next piece that you're going to have to rework it, what you would do is unpick, and it's a small stitch, so it's a little bit tricky, but don't worry. If the paper starts to come apart at that point, you can stick a bit of masking tape on it, or the paper's coming out anyway. So that's the only thing. It's when you're going through it again, it can start to... But just take the excess paper out of the way and stitch on it. I've done that as well. Yeah.
So this is normal behaviour for your foundation paper piecing. I've got some messages. Denise in West Yorkshire says, "Hi, I think your tips and ideas are great, especially the points on your quilting. I will certainly be using your ideas to get a better finish." Oh,
thank you, Denise. That's lovely.
And another one, Sue in Worcestershire says, "What a great morning. Love your new guest, Jenny. And please tell her that her guest dress is gorgeous," says Sue. Give us a spin.
Shall I give you a spin?
Yeah.
This is the Megan dress, actually. It's a pattern by Tilly and the Buttons.
Oh, right.
And it's a quilting cotton that I used to make it. It's a cotton and steel quilting cotton that I really, really loved. So I just interfaced it to give it a bit more structure and things. But
fabulous.
And put the bit of pipe in. Just so to break it up a little bit so it wasn't completely crazy from top to bottom.
So anybody that hasn't yet met Jenni from the earlier hour, a quilter, dressmaker, foundation paper piecer, but you also make your own patterns as well.
Yes.
So all round incredibly talented lady. What an absolute pleasure to have you on the show.
Thank you
so
I've
much.
I've had a lovely time, thank you.
Will you come back?
That I
is
will.
The $24,000 question. You will come back?
Yes, with an exciting project.
Oh, it's already planned?
Yes.
Or are you just going to make sure it is?
No, I will definitely be back soon. Am I allowed to say?
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm doing some work with Liberties of London. So I have always used their fabrics and loved them since I was a little kid, and I've been down at the archives looking behind the scenes, and there's some wonderful quilting cottons coming soon, and I'll be here to show everybody them.
You heard it here first. Oh, exciting times. Do you know what? This channel gets better and better.
2 weeks to wait, I think.
So very, very soon, more reasons to stay tuned to Sewing Quarter. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Come with me, let's have a look at these fabrics. Ha ha! Now, the book gives you all of the information that you need. It is 50 different ideas for fat quarters. We've given you half metre lengths, so you've got loads, which is fabulous, of course. Okay. So there we have that one. Please check out your baskets, though, else you're going to miss out. Really? Yeah, don't miss out on that. 50 big ideas. Now, let's see, 3.5 metres, that's 7 half metres, that's 14 fat quarters, effectively, in each of these bundles, plus a thread. Now, a very pleasant pheasant is what we have for you here. Actually, do you know what? I'm just going to pop in there so that you can see how he works with all of those different colour combos. Now, this isn't necessarily to make the cushion that we've made today, because this is a looser weave on the pheasant, but there are so many other ideas within that fat quarter book. You're going to find so many to play with, and I know that you love that fabric. Excellent. Now, the stars, of course. Super pretty. What a pretty bundle that is. Really gorgeous. And this, again, $27.95, 3.5 metres of fabric there. So
loads to play with, so you can have a good go. Now, the cushion that we had made, that Jenni made, was out of this bundle here. Now, yesterday, if you watch the shows, you'll know that the Harvest Tilda range is not coming back. When it's gone, it's gone. So when you see it in a bundle like this, grab it, and then you've got those contrasting colours that are going to go. And then we've got the Scandi, which is what we made today. Say we. Jenni did all the hard work. There it is. Slight wink towards Christmas with this one, $31.95, WJGC33. That's your code to grab that one. Now, coming up tomorrow, what have we got? Tilly Rose is back. Excellent. And at 8 a.m. we're making... No, no, it's not. It's Jess Entwistle. My mistake, sorry. Well, it's actually producer Paul's mistake, but I'll take that one for him. 8 a.m., we've got a sewing machine cushion. At 9 a.m., under £15. We do love those. And then at 10 a.m., totally totes. And then at 11 a.m., it's all about storage. Let's face it, if we can make more room, then that means that we can fit more in our sewing rooms, right? Yeah. I'm going to go with that. So it's your essential sewing coming up tomorrow. Do join myself and Jess Entwistle. We're in for a whole load of fun, especially if I know that lady. Do have a lovely rest of the day as well. Check out your baskets. Make sure that you grab everything that you need today. Check out as many times as you like. You're only ever going to pay that one lot of £2.95 PMP. I will see you bright and early tomorrow morning. Have a fabulous rest of the day. Bye-bye.
By popular demand, the under £15 hour is back. For one fun-filled hour, we'll be bringing you a plethora of sewing tools, accessories, gadgets, and haberdashery essentials, all at an affordable price. This show promises to be a fast and furious showcase of great products that you never realised you needed until you saw them in action. So join us on Thursday, the 5th of October at 9 a.m. and get ready to restock your sewing studio, only on Sewing Quarter, Freeview Channel 78.